This HD broadcast is brought to you by Argent Mortgage. Ask your mortgage broker about Argent or log on to argentloans.com.
War eagle fly down the field, ever to conquer, never to yield. War eagle feelings are true, fight on orange and blue. Go, go, go. Tough, you'll always be home sweet home to me. Good old Rocky Top, Rocky Top, Tennessee.
Seize the moment.
That is what I had to do a decade ago with the weight of a volunteer nation on my shoulders.
Manning back to throw, looking into the end zone for the post route. Touchdown, Big Orange!
An SEC championship, four consecutive bowl bids, and the Heisman Trophy later. We help restore the glory to Auburn football. Now, in their final SEC game of their career, three Tiger seniors, all in the same backfield, quarterback Jason Campbell.
Here's Campbell, goes deep in the end zone. Go! It's down!
And running backs, Ronnie H2 Brown.
Ronnie Brown, touchdown!
And Cadillac Williams.
To Williams, waltz in!
All return for one more run at the title.
This is the SEC Championship.
The champion for 1997, the University of Tennessee Volunteers.
Where age doesn't define the player, but where a player can be defined for the ages.
Kicking on the way, the kick is long and high. Good!
For these three seniors, friends and teammates, their moment in time has arrived. A time to seize the moment.
Welcome you to the SEC Championship presented by Dr. Pepper from the Georgia Dome in Atlanta. Second meeting of the season. The undefeated Auburn Tigers, their head coach, Tommy Tuberville. The twice defeated Tennessee Volunteers, their head coach, Philip Fulmer. Smokey's ready. Fans are as well. Peyton Manning and Bo Jackson obviously are, though neither can sing. It's the SEC Championship presented by Dr. Pepper. We'll return to the Georgia Dome right after this.
CBS Sports coverage of the SEC Championship game presented by Dr. Pepper is sponsored by Dr. Pepper, Sonic, Miller High Life, and by Pontiac.
Was then and this is now, 34-10 in the first game between these two teams back in October. Vern Lundquist, Todd Blackledge, along with Tracy Wolfson, we welcome you to Atlanta. Todd, how tough for one team to beat another twice in the same year?
Well, I go against what a lot of people think. I think if you beat a team convincingly in their stadium, you have a little mental edge, and I think Auburn has that. But what Auburn has to do in the game tonight, they've got to come in and be focused, but they also have to play loose. They've won 11 games this year by having an aggressive, let-it-rip attitude. The other thing they've got to do, they've got to make Tennessee defend the whole field. Their offensive balance is what's made them special this year, whether it's Jason Campbell throwing or Ronnie Brown and Carnell Williams running it. They've got to make Tennessee defend everything. Now, when you turn it over and talk about Tennessee, what do they have to do? Six turnovers when they played before. They must protect the football. That is quarterback Rick Clausen's number one job tonight. But most importantly for Tennessee, their defense must be stout early. Keep an eye on defensive tackle Jesse Mahalona because he sets the tempo for the Volunteer defense.
Auburn leads the series 24-21 and 3. 34-10 Tigers in the first meeting. The last time, the only time they have met in the Georgia Dome. Tennessee won the championship 30-29. Tennessee won the toss. They have elected to defer the option to the second half. That means they will kick off in the form of James Wilhoit. You see 25 touchbacks and 61 kicks. Carnell Williams to the left. Devin Aromashadu is to the right. Auburn excels in special teams play. Tennessee has been abysmal. Here's the kick. This is a good one. Nice start. And Cadillac Williams, a bit surprisingly, decides to bring it out, and he is dropped inside the 15-yard line. Ben Green made the tackle.
Well, one of the first things I said, you must not be tentative. Play aggressive. Carnell Williams, a little hesitation on the return. We know he's a great returner, but a little hesitation causes Auburn to start inside their own 20 the first time with the football.
Ben Green with the tackle. Jason Campbell is the quarterback, the senior from Taylorsville, Mississippi. He has had a superb senior season. Look at that, 69%, 16 touchdowns, only 5 interceptions. With a win tonight, he becomes the all-time leader in career victories. It would be his 30th, breaking a tie that he currently holds with Stan White.
I think the biggest difference in Jason Campbell this year is not anything physically. He's always been gifted physically, but he has played this year not afraid to make mistakes, and that's been all the difference in the world, his confidence level.
You notice they've scored on 8 of 11 drives. They've only punted once on their first drive of the ball game. Here's Campbell going deep. Courtney Taylor wide open. Blown coverage, he's still loose. Tennessee secondary, very, very suspect, and we see it right off the bat. 56 yards.
Well, they went play action right away. Tennessee probably thinking run right away. This is Courtney Taylor, and they're going to just cross him. It's not a complicated route, but nobody stays with Courtney Taylor. They have him on the short route, and then when he turns him over, there's nobody deep. And Jason Campbell finds the right guy, and just like that, Auburn with another big play.
They'll go from the shotgun with a first down at the 30-yard line. Campbell 5 yards back. There's a play fake, and Campbell will run. He doesn't do this a lot, but he does it effectively.
Well, and I was at practice Wednesday, and Tommy Tuberville said, we are going to run more with Jason tonight.
And let's check the starting lineup. Presented by Dr. Pepper. Up front, McNeil, Grubbs, Engel, Lindsey, and Troy Reddick. Carnell Williams and Ronnie Brown, the stellar seniors in the backfield. Aromashadu and Taylor, the wideouts, and Cooper Wallace is the tight end. Tommy Tuberville, what a difference 1 year makes. What a difference.
He could write a book, I think.
Probably will.
Yeah.
Second down and 4. Jake Slaughter's in as the fullback. Here's play fake, and he's got a man wide open. It's Wallace, the tight end.
Boy.
Inside the 5. Cooper Wallace. Don't use him often, but they use him effectively.
Well, the scary thing for Tennessee is Auburn has thrown 2 passes, and in both cases, the wide receiver has been wide open. Now, this is Cooper Wallace here. It's just a crossing route off the bootleg. You've got to respect the run fake. You've got to respect Ronnie and Carnell. That gets the linebackers going. Kevin Burnett out of position, and Cooper Wallace, the tight end, crosses right behind him for the completion.
First and goal at the 3, Slaughter, the fullback. Cadillac Williams is the tailback. Here's the handoff. Lead blocked by Slaughter. Williams to the 1. Struggling. Fumbles in the end zone. It's loose and recovered.
Cole Bennett got it.
Cole Bennett, the backup tight end. Touchdown, Auburn.
About to say this has been way too easy. easy for Auburn because it looked like Carnell was going to kind of knife his way into the end zone, but he lost the ball, but Auburn still gets the touchdown.
John Vaughn on for the extra point. He's missed once this year. Not this time.
Carnell Williams, very good on the goal line. The hit by Jonathan Wade, knocked the ball loose. And then Cole Bennett, alertly, not the first guy to get to it, but the guy that secured the football in the end zone. A couple different players had a shot at it. Cole Bennett will be able to tell his grandkids, I scored a touchdown in the SEC championship game a long time ago.
The Auburn Tigers have now scored on 9 of 12 first possessions. Welcome back to the Georgia Dome. 7-0, 4 plays, 86 yards. That is the fastest score in SEC championship history. Cole Bennett got it with a fumble recovery after Cadillac Williams was hit and dropped the ball. Philip Yost will kick off. Gerald Riggs is back to return it. Mention how abysmal special teams have been for Tennessee. They rank 103rd of 117 teams in Division I in kickoff returns. And it's a moot point on this one as Yost drives it 10 yards deep. Let's go back to the touchdown.
Well, let's take a look where Cole Bennett was. Here he is right here. He's the backside tight end. The play is going the other way. They actually had a defensive tackle or offensive tackle playing tight end on the other side. Jonathan Wade comes in with a good hit right on the football. Carnell Williams was not ready for that hit, and Cole Bennett comes up with a touchdown. Watch Jonathan Wade, and Carnell normally knows where everybody's coming from, had no idea where Jonathan Wade was coming from, put the shoulder right on the football, and Cole Bennett came up with the touchdown.
Now, Rick Clawson, the junior from Thousand Oaks, California, and a quarterback. He hands it off to second man through, that Cedric Houston.
Good run. Good first play for Tennessee.
Well, Rick Clawson started his career. He's Casey Clawson's younger brother. Started his career at LSU, transferred, sat out last season, began this year as the number three quarterback. Injuries to Eric Ainge, Brent Schaefer, they are out. And Clawson is getting a start in his third game. He played very, very well last week in the win over Kentucky.
And he's gotten better the more that he's played. And what he gives Tennessee is a little more maturity and ability to do things at the line.
Houston forced back inside. Travis Williams made it after Jay Ratliff forced it. That's a loss of three.
The one thing about this Auburn defense, they're not one of the bigger defenses you'll see, but they're very fast and they're fundamentally very sound. And when you do get them blocked, they don't stay blocked very long. They use their quickness and their speed to their advantage. They get off blocks very well, very quickly, and they get you in third down, and that is where they have been outstanding.
Lead the country in scoring defense, and they're top 10 in three other categories.
Not bad, huh?
No. Third and six. Here's Clawson back to throw. Blitz coming. He fires it. It's dropped. A little behind the senior Tony Brown, but that's a should have had.
Well, it was pretty good protection, and I think Rick Clawson may have hurried that one just a little bit. He had a little better protection than maybe he thought he was going to get on this first third down play. He threw it a little too soon, and it was behind Tony Brown. But again, when you're the underdog like Tennessee, you've got to come up with as many of those plays as you can.
Three and out in this one. Here's Dustin Colquitt. And that is not his best effort. He's not having a great season. He was an All-American a year ago. And here's Cadillac Williams back to return the punt. And he doesn't get anywhere. 44-yard punt for Colquitt. 1 yard on the return. But three and out for Tennessee, just as they went three and out in game one in October. And big plays did them in then. Two huge plays have given Auburn a 7-0 lead.
Welcome back. Tigers up 7-0. Auburn can't control the polls, but they can control what kind of legacy they leave. A win today, and these Tigers could become the first in school history to go 12-0 on the season. A victory will also give them their first SEC championship game win and their first SEC title in 15 years. Head coach Tommy Tuberville put it like this. He said, to get to Atlanta and win here is our number one goal. Only us as coaches and players know how hard it is to do what we have done so far. To finish it off is one of the hardest things in sports. He said, you just have to go out and do it.
Back to you, Vern.
All right, Tracy, 7-0 here. Ball on the 34, second Auburn possession. Cadillac Williams in the backfield. Ronnie Brown, number 23, lines up and a wing to the left. Here's the handoff to Cadillac Williams. Gets across the 35 and out to the 38-yard line. That's a gain of 4. Well, Auburn in the battle for BCS championship game standings. USC and Oklahoma have been 1-2 in everything all season long, and they were 1-2 when the BCS polls first came out. Auburn trying to vault over one or the other.
And USC playing crosstown rival UCLA tonight in a bit of a tussle, 17-10 right now in that ball game.
Second down and 6. And again, Campbell out of the spread. Four-man rush for Tennessee. A little inside shovel. Here's Ronnie Brown. Zips across the 50, down to the 49. A quick gain of 13 for number 23.
Well, what we're seeing is we're seeing that aggressive offensive mentality that Al Borges has brought to this Auburn offense. He's got a senior quarterback. He's got a pair of very talented senior running backs. He can use them in a lot of different ways. And when you are two-dimensional, legitimately, you are very difficult to defend. And Auburn is very two-dimensional in their offense this season.
First and 10 after the gain of 13. That is the third play in excess of 10 yards already. Play fake. Campbell under pressure has a relief man. And there's Ben Obomanu. Nobody around him. And Obomanu is belted out of bounds, and there's a little jawing going on. That's a gain of 16. That is the fourth play. Over 10 yards already.
And I'm a little bit surprised, not because of Auburn, but because of Tennessee's defense. John Chavis told us over and over, when we played them the first time, as we take a look at Obomanu coming as an underneath route, an outlet receiver, and Jason Campbell found him. But John Chavis said, hey, look, when we played them in October, they had 5 plays in the first half that accounted for 188 yards. Other than that, we played pretty well. Well, now we're barely into this game, and as you mentioned, already 4 plays over 10 yards, all of them passes.
Campbell has completed 4 for 106. And off to Cadillac Williams, goes left, jukes the defender. That was Jonathan Wade. There's some laundry on the ground.
Yes, indeed. Well, we've seen some missed tackles already in the ballgame tonight for Tennessee's defense. This one doesn't even qualify as a missed tackle. This one is more of a leave you sprawling on the Georgia Dome turf. Watch Carnell Williams just stop, plant the right foot, and boop, bounce back outside. And Jonathan Wade, who's a very athletic corner, no chance.
And a first down at the 20-yard line. Whistle before the snap. Well, this Tennessee defense, let's introduce them to you before changes are made. Defensive line, Paris Harrelson, Turk McBride, Jesse Mahalona, and Carlton Neal. The linebackers, Omar Gaither, Jason Mitchell, Kevin Burnett, the senior. And the secondary, which has been a problem. Rashawn Fellows, Jason Allen's had a great year. Corey Campbell, Jonathan Hefney. And here is John Chavis, the defensive coordinator. Long-time assistant coach at his alma mater, Tennessee.
And I'll tell you, it's been a tough year for him because, you know, you mentioned Jason Allen. He has had a great year in terms of tackling, but they're last in the SEC in pass defense. Way too many big plays they've given up.
Here's a pass. It's caught by Ronnie Brown, and a good job defensively will limit that. After the penalty was walked off against Auburn, it was a false start penalty, and that tackle made by Turk McBride.
You know, I mentioned at the beginning of the show how important it was for Tennessee to play well defensively early. Auburn has outscored their opponents in the first half 194-32, and the only two teams that have hung around in the fourth quarter, LSU and Alabama, against this Auburn team, did it because their defense played well early and really took the game to Auburn.
Second down and 15 now. Campbell, play action again, looks deep. He'll scramble, gets a nice block, finds a man open, it's Ronnie Brown. He got a terrific block from Ben Grubbs.
Yeah, that's pretty good downfield defense that time by Tennessee, forcing Jason Campbell to go underneath. It was second down and long. And
and Auburn tried to flood the field. They tried to get three receivers over on the same side of the field, and Jason Campbell was forced to take the shortest alternative.
Now take a look at the first quarter dominance by Auburn. 116-12. Second quarter, I mean, the only quarter that's even resembled anything close is number four.
Yeah, and that's when all their starters are out.
Right. Third and five. Auburn loads up the left side. Mix is the middle of three. Here's Campbell. Half roll, fires it. It's caught by Obamanu. He appears to have a first down. He is belted by Jason Allen. But I think Obamanu had enough to give Auburn a first and goal. Jason Allen, who told us yesterday, I am so excited. I have never played in a championship game at any level.
Well, he better strap it up because Auburn's coming. Here's Obamanu. This is like a little pick play. These guys go in, he goes out, and no defender is able to get out there with Obamanu. See, defenses call that a pick. Offensive players call that a rub play. Now, however you interpret it, it's a first down for Auburn.
Must be a rub because picks are illegal.
And no, the yellow flags were on the field.
First down and goal. Just. And the play clock down to five. Motion. 3 point. Now there is a flag in the far side.
It'll probably be offsides on Tennessee.
Yep, so it is a free play.
Play. So
looks like Jason Hall might have jumped.
One other thing to keep in mind about this ball game. Tennessee played last week and had to fight to the very end. They scored the winning touchdown with 12 seconds left to beat Kentucky 37-31. Auburn had the week off. This is a more rested football team and a healthier football team than Tennessee right now.
Replay first down.
This is Steve Landis, who is refereeing his final game tonight. He's decided to call it a career as a referee in the Southeastern Conference. And after the penalty is marked off, it's first and goal from just inside the five. This has been all Auburn all the time. Cadillac Williams is the deep back. Campbell under Jeremy Engle. Play fake. Campbell comes right. Looks. Nobody open. Good pressure. He throws it away.
Good defense and a good decision by Jason Campbell.
Paris Harrelson, number 98. And Campbell and Harrelson will have a little chat.
You don't see Jason talk too much. Now, those are both Mississippi guys. Paris Harrelson's from Flora, Mississippi. Jason Campbell from Taylorsville, Mississippi. And it's a clean hit and a good to see. Well, there is a hand up in the face mask, but Steve Landis was on the back side of it. Maybe couldn't see that.
Paris Harrelson. First name is spelled P-A-R-Y-S. We chatted with him in midseason, said, why isn't it just P-A-R-I-S? He said, let me call my mom and find out. Called his mother while we were meeting with him. She said, Paris with a Y sounds more masculine.
Yeah. That was a great moment.
Second down and goal. Toss left. Cadillac. Belted. Touchdown. Auburn. They're up by 13. Straight game with a rushing touchdown. That is a new Auburn Tiger record. As a senior at Etowah High School in Etowah, Alabama, Cadillac Williams agreed to attend Tennessee. Tennessee, Tommy Tuberville took five of his assistants, went to Cadillac's home and said, could we talk? He agreed to make an official visit to Auburn, signed there, and is capping an illustrious career. Extra point is good. 8:35 to go, first quarter. This is a Tennessee Volunteer worst nightmare. NFL regional coverage tomorrow. We've got five games early, headlined by New England at Cleveland and late Denver at San Diego. And Kansas City at Oakland. It all begins with the NFL today, tomorrow, 12 noon Eastern time. Boomer Esiason will catch the train back into New York after his work at the Army-Navy game day. Carnell Williams, 14-0, his touchdown in the ninth consecutive game. There's his mom, Sherry Jackson, and quite a tribute to the three seniors that we spotlighted in the open. She wears a jersey. Well, you can't see it now because the hefty fella stood up with no sense of drama. Here's the kick. And this will be Riggs at the goal line. Riggs across the 20 and out to the 23-yard line. And Sherry Jackson, we were mentioning, she's from Atala, Alabama, wears a special jersey with number 23 on the front, 24 on the other side, and 17 on the sleeves. Really, trust me on this. She truly does.
Well, that's quite a backfield. She's well represented because those three young men have played at an All-American level this year and may all three end up being first-round draft picks in the NFL next spring.
First and 10, Tennessee. Three and out the first time. They're down by 14. Hand off, Cedric Houston, number 21, spilled at the 25.
I want to go back to the touchdown because it's worth watching the execution of the blocking. Three great blocks. Watch the two wide receivers and then watch big Marcus McNeil go out to make his block. This is perfect execution to get the running back to the corner. McNeil knocks out Jonathan Wade, and then you see the strength of Carnell Williams run through Jason Allen again.
And one of the signature plays of game one was Jason Allen being rocked back on his heels by Ronnie Brown. Second down. Here's the change, Rick Clawson. Into the left side, it's caught by Tony Brown. Nice open field job, Montavis Pitts. Number 19. And we need to introduce you to the Tennessee offense. You've seen Rick Clawson, the junior from Thousand Oaks, California. The offensive line, Aaron Sears, whose brother Kevin is a starting linebacker for Auburn. Smith, Respert, Gandy, and Tolina. Houston, Corey Anderson in the backfield, Swain and Hannon, along with Tony Brown, the three wideouts.
Well, this is where Auburn has been really tough. When they get you in third and seven plus, they are very difficult to convert on.
Auburn brings four. Backside pass is the left side. It's tipped away by Carlos Rogers, the All-American, number 14.
Well, a couple problems there on that play. Number one, it's a really long throw. They were on the left hash, and he's throwing it out all the way to the right sideline. Number two, you're going against the best cover corner, I think, in the SEC this year in Carlos Rogers, who's very rangy at 6'1", 200. That ball's in the air a long time, and Rogers able to make the play easily.
For the season, only 17 passes have been completed in front of Carlos Rogers. He's been thrown at only 63 times now, including that last pass.
And they're trying to bait Dustin Colquitt to raise up and throw the football here. They moved on the coverage.
Oh, boy, it looked like they were coming. There is contact, and there is no flag. And a fair catch call by Carnell Williams at the 35-yard line.
I love the aggressiveness of Auburn's football team. They've been aggressive on offense, they've been aggressive on defense, and going after the punter, aggressive on special teams. They know they're the better team coming in, and they're playing like it so far.
Time now for the Home Depot coach's decision. It's called Let's Go Deep on the first play.
Yeah, good call by Al Borges, but we've got a special way to show it to you. It's called Stro Motion. Watch Jason Campbell. He's been very accurate this year, almost 70% completions, a lot of deep balls. Watch the beautiful arc on the ball. That's just one football, believe me. But perfect throw to the outside receiver, Courtney Taylor, and right out of the box, Auburn was off to a fast start.
You know, if Peter Costas gets ill for our golf coverage, you can take his spot and analyze Tiger Woods' swing. No?
No.
No?
I don't know enough about the golf swing. Mine's pretty ugly.
Okay. Two possessions, two touchdowns. Here's Silas Daniels, number 85, who starts in motion, then sets up. Here's the handoff. No, play action. Campbell. He wants to go deep for Silas Daniels. Goes short instead. Aroma Shadu with Omar Gaither in the neighborhood. Cannot hang on.
And Tennessee looked a little more settled down on that play. Again, very aggressive call. Good play fake, but Tennessee in position. Omar Gaither was in position enough to disrupt that throw and catch to Aroma Shadu. But if you look at what's happened so far, total domination by Auburn. And the last two times these teams have played, last year in Auburn and in October in Knoxville, the same thing has happened. Auburn has jumped on them right away and buried them early in the football game.
Second and 10 now with a 14-0 lead. The ball at the 35. Campbell, Williams. And it'll be the first third and long. And for an injury update, let's check in with Tracy Wolfson.
Thanks, Vern. You're not seeing Tennessee free safety Jason Allen in the game right now. He has a severe laceration on his right elbow. He's been taken to the locker room. They're going to clean him up and stitch him up, and they're hoping he can return.
I wonder if that didn't happen when Cadillac Williams rolled him over on the touchdown run.
And that's a key loss because they're already hurting at the safety position. That has been one of their real weak points, the strong safety position. Jason Allen, their leading tackler by far.
Third and 10, Tennessee will go with three men down. Mahalona just hurried off at a defensive tackle spot. Here's Engel checking. Snaps it back. They rush five. Campbell across the middle. The catch is made by Ronnie Brown, but it will force the first Auburn punt of the evening.
And that was a good defensive call by John Chavis to go after Jason Campbell, even though it was third and long, try to make him throw short, and that's what they got. They got pressure. They brought extra people. They knocked Jason Campbell down, and they forced him to throw underneath, and then they made the tackle short of the first down. Good rush, good coverage, and a punt for Auburn.
Brings on Cody Bliss. You think he's gotten tired? I don't believe so. Eight times in the last eight games. And this one, well, maybe
looks
he is tired. Yeah.
Well, it looks like he's only punted a few times.
That was pretty poor. My friend Pat Hayden would now say, "Shank you very much."
Yes, he would. Very appropriately.
15-yard punt. 1-5. At the conclusion of tonight's game, go to CBS Sportsline and get your SEC Champs gear. Just click on shop at CBSSportsline.com.
Well, good field position now for Tennessee, and I think Randy Sanders, the offensive coordinator, he's got to be a little aggressive. The best time, I think, to throw on Auburn is off of play action on early downs and try to get a big chunky yardage, maybe even try to get Robert Meacham involved in the game, number three. He's their big play receiver.
High formation on first and 10, best field position by far. Here's Clawson going deep right side. They go at Montavis Pitts, and he can't hang on. Chris Hannon had Pitts beaten, had both hands on the football, and it goes incomplete.
And I'll say it again, when you are the underdog team, coming in, you have got to make these plays. A great call by Randy Sanders. A great throw by Rick Clawson. And Chris Hannon has to come up with that catch. He gets both hands on it. Yes, it was a dive. Yes, it made it tough. But if you want to be in this kind of a game, you've got to make those plays.
Randy Sanders, who was a quarterback at Tennessee in the mid-80s, offensive coordinator, has worked with three quarterbacks now and a patched-up offensive line. He's had a good year as the offensive coordinator. Here's Clawson. Zings this one out to Jason Swain, and it's too high, and Montavis Pitts comes up, and he'll do a little chatting. Well, Schaefer and Ainge were declared co-starters by Philip Fulmer back in August. Brent Schaefer was the first to go down. That happened, a separated shoulder against South Carolina. And then 3.5 weeks ago against Notre Dame, final play of the half. Talk about inexplicable. They decide to go out of the shotgun. Ainge out for the season. In the Notre Dame game, Clawson came on, threw a costly interception to Mike Goolsby that turned out to be the game-winning points in that loss to Notre Dame. Here's Clawson. Zings it left side. Corey Anderson, no thank you. Stanley McClover, who may be the most enthusiastic player on this Auburn defense.
Well, I'll guarantee you one thing. He's the fastest defensive lineman in the league. Here he is. Now, this is a blitz, and he's got to cover the back, and he does it. They blitz the safety, Will Herring, and they drop the defensive end to cover the running back on the screen. He didn't have to run very far, but he was all over that play. And this is a very well-disciplined Auburn defense under Gene Chizik.
And for the third time, Tennessee goes three and out. Colquitt is on the punt. Carnell Williams this time has camped at the 10-yard line.
And Colquitt needs to punt like an All-American for Tennessee tonight. I know he's had a tough year, but they need him to be strong tonight.
This one sky high. And a fair catch called by Cadillac Williams and taken at the 17-yard line. Well, he is averaging, Colquitt, 41.4 this season of the kicking Colquitt family, and that's not good by his standards. Tuesday on NCIS, a serial killer is loose on the web. Now the Naval Criminal Investigative Service must send one of their own into his domain. Mark Harmon stars in a new episode of NCIS Tuesday, 8 o'clock, 7 Central on CBS, America's most watched network. 14-0, latter stages, opening quarter. Two touchdowns, a fumble recovery in the end zone by Cole Bennett, a Cadillac Williams fumble at the one, and then Williams with a touchdown on the ground. Here's Ronnie Brown, and he's belted. So that's about four good defensive plays.
They've settled down a little bit. And it looked like they were going to get run out of the building on the first couple possessions, but the last four or five plays, John Chavis's defense has settled down a little bit. Now the key is, if they're solid against the run, they can't give up more big plays in that passing game. They've got to find a way to cover the receivers closer and get a little more pressure on Jason Campbell. It's one thing to play well against the run, but then when you give up big chunks of yardage with passing plays, it really negates what you do up front.
On second and 10, spread formation, Ronnie Brown goes wide to the left where he'll live. Stop. Here's Campbell, comes back to the right, underneath Ogbonu. Nifty play.
Bad tackling. Nifty running, bad tackling by Tennessee. And you're not going to just knock guys down. Ogbonu's a 200-pound receiver. I mean, he's not a little flyweight out there. And so when you just hit him, he just bounces off a few yards and keeps running. About three or four missed tackles on that play and brings Auburn very close to another first down.
So close, they will bring out the chain. Ben Ogbonu, 22 receptions for the year, six touchdowns, so his touchdown per catch ratio is outstanding. Just short.
Nine missed tackles in the ballgame so far now for Tennessee. And remember, the last 2 weeks, this team has won very close games over Vanderbilt and Kentucky. But they've given up 743 yards and 57 points coming into tonight. They've already given up 14 in this one. So this has not been a three-week stretch of defense for John Chavis and the Tennessee Volunteers that he's going to be quick to remember.
Well, the tackling has been so poor that in a conference call with us on Tuesday, he asked if you had any eligibility left and if you'd like to play on the defensive side of the ball.
Yeah.
He asked me, but I don't think he was
really
serious.
Desperate, I think, for both of us.
Yes. Third and short. Quarterback sneak, Campbell. Let's see where the spot is. Looks like he got it.
Should have it.
Auburn, of course, trying to become the first team to ever win 12 games in Auburn history. First SEC championship in 1987, the only national championship in the history of the school came in 1957. They were on probation back then, so did not play in a bowl game. They did go undefeated. 93, they were 11-0, probation eligible for the SEC title. In 58, 9-0-1. This has been a magical ride for Tommy Tuberville and the Auburn Tigers. Now the play clock down at 2-1.
I don't think they got it, did they?
Apparently so. Here's Campbell, fires it. Ogbonu up at the 35-yard line. Now let's go back to the studio for a Pontiac game-changing performance. Here's Tim Brando.
Taking it from 9 yards out. Do you ever notice, fellas, that no one ever questions whether USC is number one, only whether Oklahoma is number two or Auburn? Interesting, isn't it?
Yeah, it sure is.
Well, I said this a couple weeks ago, and I'm not taking anything away from USC by saying this. I think they're a great football team, but I think they were ranked number one from the very beginning because of what happened to them last year. And I think there was a lot of sentiment coming into this year that USC was the team that got left out last year, and that's not going to happen this year.
There's Campbell setting up a screen pass right side, incomplete. Well, the other factor that we've discussed a couple of times, here's Campbell holding his left foot.
He's a little slow getting up.
Jesse Mahalona got to him.
Jesse Mahalona has had a couple off weeks. But I expected him to come out and play well today, and he looks better. You see him, it's a low tackle, nothing dirty by Mahalona, just that's where he ended up getting Jason Campbell as he released the football. But Mahalona played the last couple weeks with a very heavy heart. Lost an uncle that was very close to him out in Hawaii and contemplated going back home, and has worked his way through that and looks a lot better tonight.
Third and eight. There's Campbell. He gets back, gets a good block, and finds a man. There's a flag back at the 21-yard line. This is either going to be holding or roughing. Steve Landis. Holding.
Yeah.
Well, you and I have talked about how far back Auburn began this season. Here's the BCS top three: Southern Cal, Oklahoma, and Auburn. And look at the computer edge Oklahoma has.
Yeah, that's really where Oklahoma has a clear edge over Auburn, because in the computers they're ranked number one, and Auburn is trying to pass up Oklahoma. And you better believe the Sooners are paying attention to this game right now. They'll be playing in the Big 12 championship game against Colorado a little bit later on this evening. But that's what that means then, is it means for Auburn to jump them, they would have to really flip a lot of AP voters and coaches voters in those two polls over this weekend.
Oh, bad snap. Cody Bliss loses it, and the Tennessee Volunteers will have the ball at the 14-yard line. I don't think the snap was that high. He just slipped it.
It was high, but he's got to be able to catch that. Now, with the first time out there, he shanked the punt, and that's what Tommy Tuberville is saying, is, hey, our special teams have been a strength all year, and you're two times out on the field, it's been a weakness. The shank, a high snap, but he's got to catch that one. And Tennessee, who is struggling to find a break in this game, just found one.
15-yard punt for Bliss, and then a bobble, and Eddie Graham, the special teams coach, is in his face now. These are not going to be pleasant moments before halftime for Cody Bliss. First down at the 14. High formation for Tennessee. They hand it off to Houston. He comes left and is cut down by Travis Williams. Another look at the snap, which was just a little bit high.
Well, again, Auburn special teams have been very strong this year. Eddie Graham, the special teams coach. Tommy Tuberville spends a lot of time with special teams. And on that team, the punt team, they have eight of their starters, because that particular part of the special teams can affect field position so much with big returns or block kicks. But you expect your punter to catch the snap.
Meacham split to the left. This is Corey Anderson in motion, wide to the left. And here's Clawson back to throw. Across the middle, caught by Houston. Darts left, and that should be a first and goal, Tennessee.
Nice job by Rick Clawson, not panicking, and going to a secondary receiver who was his outlet in Cedric Houston. That's the one thing that Rick Clawson, I think, has done since he's come in. He doesn't throw the ball as well as Eric Ainge. He doesn't run the ball nearly as well as Brent Schaefer, but he understands the game. He had an older brother that was an excellent quarterback here in Casey Clawson, and he knows what to do with the football.
Tennessee has not been effective in the red zone, what they call the orange zone, this year. First and goal, handoff Houston, goes right, gets one, down to the two. Matter of fact, the Clawson family, Casey Clawson is here. He was the losing quarterback in Tennessee's loss to LSU here in 2001. He's going to play in the NFL Developmental League in Europe this spring. His sister, Katie, to his right, she's a freshman at Tennessee, and the younger brother, Jimmy, is a sophomore at Oaks Christian. He's thrown for 51 touchdowns at Thousand Oaks, California. They've got a game tonight in the state semifinals. Handoff up the middle, up over the top. Yep. Touchdown, Tennessee. Yep. Flag on the far side.
There is a flag down, but I think it's offsides on Auburn. I think there was movement on the left side of the Auburn line, and I think the touchdown will stand for Tennessee.
Number four, defense was in the neutral.
Junior Rose Green is the guy that's been identified by Steve Landis. He was blitzing from the top of the formation. Credit Cedric Houston for staying with it and getting it in the end zone. And that's only the second rushing touchdown that Auburn has given up the entire season.
That's right. The only other team to score on the ground against the Tigers, of all people, Kentucky. And that was back in October. They had given up one rushing touchdown in 53 quarters until that score.
Well, the blitz was coming from the outside. You see Rose Green clearly over the line of scrimmage. Cedric Houston up and over the top. And the only way you can go up and over is if you get a push on the inside. And Casey Clawson and his dad, Jim, know that's a great way to get back in his football game.
Touchdown set up by the botched punt. That's the end of number one. We'll return to the Georgia Dome after this message and a word from your local station.
You can walk like I do and talk like me too, but nobody gonna rock with you because you can't do it like me.
Nah, you can't do it like me.
We begin quarter number two. Vern Lundquist, Todd Blackledge, Tracy Wolfson in the 2004 SEC Championship presented by Dr. Pepper. And Cody Bliss spending some moments in agony on that sideline.
And that's the defensive line coach, Don Dunn, that was shaking his head there saying, hey, we still believe in you, but don't put our defense in a hole like that anymore. You know, that's Tennessee was struggling to get in this game, and boy, they found a way to do it on the special teams right there.
James Wilhoit will kick off. Cadillac Williams and Devin Aromashadu are the deep men. Here's Will Hoyt, he of the 51-yard field goal that won the game over Florida all the way back in September. He nails this one. It goes out of the end zone. It will come back to the 20-yard line, and the Auburn Tigers will get it again with their lead now shaved to 14-7. Todd, you had a sense from what we were seeing in the first quarter, the only way Tennessee was going to get back in the game was a break, and they got a big one.
Well, they got a break from the special teams, but remember this now. I think it was set up because after those first two touchdowns, the Tennessee defense started to settle down a little bit. They forced two punts. They got a short punt the first time. They got a fumbled snap the second time. So the defense geared it up a little bit. They got the big turnover, and the offense, even though they've only gained 22 yards, they got them right back in the game.
Well, Auburn gets it first down at the 20-yard line. Jason Campbell with his backs in the eye. Jake Slaughter, the fullback, leans up to make sure he's got the count and the play, and then leads the play left side. There's a flag on the near side of the field. Mahalona made the tackle. And a little conversation here with the officiating crew.
I mentioned that Jesse Mahalona suffered the loss of an uncle, his uncle Moses, who was a musical performer in Hawaii, 45 years old, died rather tragically, suddenly. And it was very difficult for Jesse. He felt very alone and far away from home and family. But he has really kind of worked his way through it, and he's having a pretty good ball game here tonight. And I think he sets the tempo for this entire Tennessee defense. They feed off of his ability to be disruptive on the inside.
You saw the graphic. He had no tackles against Vanderbilt, did get three against Kentucky, and that penalty against Auburn, it's first and 15. Here's Campbell, right side, man wide open again. Boy, the secondary has not played well.
No, too much cushion.
Goodness sakes. Courtney Taylor makes the grab. Another big, big play. 26 yards.
Hey, Jim.
Hey, Ronnie.
What's that?
Ronnie, lately I've been wanting faster internet. So I got an Earthlink high-speed connection.
Seems kind of crazy to me.
Is downloading up to 70 times faster than the regular dial-up crazy, Ronnie?
Touché, Jim. But what if I don't want a crazy thing on top of my head?
It's not even real, Ronnie. Just a marketing device. To help remind people of Earthlink.
Speed, security, control. That's Earthlink High Speed. Right now, get 3 months of Earthlink High Speed for just $19.95 a month. Earthlink revolves around you.
If a moonlit moment turns into the right moment, will you be ready? You can be with Cialis. Cialis is the only erectile dysfunction tablet clinically proven to both work fast and work up to 36 hours. 36 hours to relax and take your time. 36 hours to choose the moment that's right for you and your partner. Cialis is only for men healthy enough for sexual activity. Do not take Cialis if you take nitrates for chest pain or certain alpha blockers for prostate problems or high blood pressure, as this may cause an unsafe drop in blood pressure. Don't drink alcohol in excess with Cialis. Side effects may include headache, upset stomach, delayed backache, or muscle ache. Erections lasting longer than 4 hours, though rare, require immediate medical help. Discuss your health status with your doctor and ask if Cialis is right for you. 36-hour Cialis. When the moment is right, will you be ready?
The Rose Bowl. New Year's Day, 100,000 fans will pack this place. Impressive number. Allstate has their own impressive number, 1 million. That's about how many drivers switched to Allstate last year, enough to fill 10 Rose Bowls. Why? Many of them saved an average of $278 a year. Now that calls for a parade. Championship insurance for less. That's Allstate, Stan. Are you in good hands?
It was a cold and blustery day when he took the field. But like a true grill iron master, he knew whatever Old Man Winter threw his way, nothing, not snow, not sleet, nothing would stand between him and his big, plump Ballpark Franks.
Ballpark Grill Master Franks. Be big, be meaty, be frank.
Thursday.
Grissom.
A new CSI then.
You began an affair with her in 2001, is that correct?
He's not going to answer that.
Everyone leaves in your life, don't they?
Enough! Yeah. Enough!
Yeah. A new Without a Trace after CSI Thursday.
21-7 at the half, the 2004 SEC Championship presented by Dr. Pepper. The Amazing Race is taking America by storm. As teams journey across continents, they're tested to their very limits. Don't miss the critical challenges ahead and what happens along the way. A new Amazing Race Tuesday at 9, 8 Central on CBS, America's most watched network. Doubleheader college basketball, the NCAA on CBS, next Saturday at 1:30 Eastern Time. Indiana against Kentucky, and then Stanford against Michigan State. Just a moment ago, Tracy Wolfson had a chance to chat with Auburn coach Tom Tuberville.
Coach, a big turnover heading into the half. How do you keep the momentum from swinging back their way?
Well, we were our own worst enemy on that last drive. We missed some blocks. Should have had the ball down there a little bit quicker than having to try to force one in with 13 seconds. But, you know, we played well defensively. Can't play much better than we played there. We're getting ready to probably see some deep balls, and, you know, they're going to try to get back in the game early. We just got to play sound, fundamental defense and see what happens.
Thanks a lot, Coach. Good luck in the second half.
All right, Tracy, thank you. Jason Campbell had the hot hand in the first 30 minutes. Smokey hoping to lead a comeback for the Volunteers. We'll be right back.
Fresh, made to order. Sonic's got it, others don't. At Sonic, you won't find any microwaves around here, but you will find delicious all-beef burgers served with the freshest ingredients around and made after you order them, the way you like them. It's not just good, it's Sonic good.
What's our team motto?
Aim low.
Dodge.
I'm okay!
Duck.
Ah, oh.
Dip. Dive. And dodge.
I guess I'm not really an angry person.
Dodgeball. Grab it Tuesday.
Are you angry now?
Thursday.
Go!
The ultimate winner of this challenge ends up in the final four. Guaranteed. A new Survivor Thursday and the season finale CBS Sunday.
Set for the start of the third quarter. They do this one right. The Southeastern Conference Championship It is really a celebration of the sport in this part of the country, and folks here have a passion for college football that I think is unique to the culture in the South. People declare their allegiance early on. It lasts for a lifetime, and then you follow your team and you live and die with them. Philip Yost will kick off as Tennessee will receive to open the third quarter. Here's Yost, and he chases Riggs way to the right. Out of bounds, it will come out to the 20. And the Volunteers, who had a total of 20 plays and 39 yards of offense in the first half, what do they do?
Well, I think they've got to try to throw the football, and I think they've got to try to throw on early downs. It's tough for them. They were 1 of 5 on third downs in that first half. Auburn very good when they get you in third and 7+. So I think Tennessee has to come out and throw on early downs, try to get Rick Clawson in a little bit of a rhythm. I don't think they abandon the run completely, but if they throw with some success, that'll help their running game.
Well, they've got a first down and 10 at the 20-yard line, trailing by 14. Out of the spread. Play fake. Clawson still has it. He's being chased by McGlover, and the pass is caught up at the 30-yard line by Tony Brown. And let's break it down statistically for you. The first half stats presented by Dr. Pepper.
Everything in favor of Auburn, starting with the score and ending with the time of possession. I mean, they totally dominated. Look at that total yards, 303-39, but they got a first down on the first play here to the third quarter, and they threw the football. And again, for Rick Clawson, anything to get in a little bit of a rhythm. If you can stretch this defense a little, that will open up some creases to run the football.
First down and 10. They fake the reverse. The handoff goes to Riggs. He darts into the secondary. It's Houston. A flag is down. It's 21 instead of 31. We'll see if the score stands. 70 yards if it stands, but it's coming back.
Where that flag was thrown, I think they are going to get an outside, possibly a receiver blocking. But it was an excellent cutback by Cedric Houston, and the fake reverse helped that play significantly. You wonder, why does a team run a fake reverse like
during
that?
During the run, holding number 14 on the offense, 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul.
It was not 14. It was holding on 14. Carlos Rogers is number 14. He's the guy that was held. I think it was Chris Hannon, number 13, who was the guilty guy of holding. Chris Hannon, the receiver, gets a hold of Carlos Rogers, and it's so unnecessary because all he's got to do is just be a gnat, you know, just kind of stand there in his way and screen him away from Cedric Houston, and Tennessee has a touchdown.
It becomes an 11-yard run after the penalty is walked off and results in a first down and 6 and a glare from Philip Fulmer.
Oh, boy.
What an electrifying way it would have been
for Tennessee.
And just like Philip said, if we can do something in the first 5 minutes here, the second half, we'll have a chance. As you look at what they did in the first half, other than that one where they got the fumbled snap on the punt, they did nothing offensively, but they got a completion on first down, and they broke a big one on their next play, only to have it called back for the holding.
10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul results in a first down and 6 for Tennessee. Draw play, left side, another big hole. It's Riggs, number 31, and he gets all the way to the 50-yard line.
Well, we've seen a couple different runs. They faked the reverse the time before that. This time it's the old counter trap. They pull the backside guard and tackle. Watch these guys come, the fullback and the guard, and they're going to get a nice play. It's the guard and the fullback, and they kick out, and there's just a huge hole right in there for Gerald Riggs.
That's a gain of 15, the longest run of the game. Here's Clawson getting it in the hands of Riggs. He goes right and ran up the back of his tackle. Travis Williams, number 51, defensively for the Auburn Tigers.
And one of the guys that's in the game right now for Tennessee is Cody Douglas, who was the starting right guard, has not practiced for a month. He injured his foot in the Georgia game. He has not practiced at all for a month. They thought he might get some plays in today, and he's in there right now at the right guard.
And he had Riggs running up his back on that last play. Second down. Here's Rick Clawson. Third string quarterback to start the year. Behind him is C.J. Leak.
Play clock's at three. He's not going to get this one off.
And just does.
No, he did not.
Did not.
When you have a little offensive momentum, you don't want to kill that by getting a delay of game. Don't get too tricky. Get up there and try to knock him off the ball.
For the snap, number 70 of the offense lifted his hand. 5-yard penalty, still second down.
That was Cody Douglas. Todd just talked about his lack of practice time. So they open with a 70-yard run, wiped out by a penalty on Chris Hannon. That negated a touchdown. Now they have a big first down and followed by another penalty.
And right now, Rick Clawson's got to be just thinking, let's just get a good play, a positive play here, so we can get at least half of this yardage back on this second down play.
Gerald Riggs, the deep back. Play fake, Clawson pumps. He's nailed as he lets it go, and it's incomplete. Intended for C.J. Fayton. Boy, Clawson really got belted.
Yeah, he was hit by Quentin Groves, who is one of the two young defensive ends on this team, along with Stanley McGlover, that both have 7.5 sacks. Groves came from the backside and really laid it on Rick Clawson. But this Auburn defense, they have two youngsters that are their best pass rushers, and they bring them in certain role situations to rush the passer, and they're both extremely fast.
McGlover and Groves each has 7.5 sacks for the season. It's 3rd and 12. Clawson on third down, yet to complete a pass. Looks over at Randy Sanders again. Pulls up, lets it go, inside, bobbled.
Well, that's two now we've seen.
Yep. That was Brett Smith.
Brett Smith again has got to make that catch. They got the protection. This time Rick Clawson steps up and makes the good throw. And Brett Smith's got to come down with this ball. If he catches it, he probably keeps running for the first down for Tennessee. And we've seen Rick Clawson rush one and make a bad throw. That time he hung in there and made a good throw, but he didn't get help from his receiver.
That brings on Dustin Colquitt for the fifth time tonight, averaging 42.5.
Boy, what a change of events. They have the touchdown run and a penalty that really didn't have to occur. It didn't affect the outcome of the play.
Nice and high for Colquitt. He's had a very effective night and has negated Carnell Williams' ability
yes,
to return punts.
He sure has. He's done a nice job.
That was a beauty. But oh, what might have been for Tennessee. Philip Fulmer telling Tracy Wolfson as they came back on the field, or as they left the field, we need to do something in the first 5 minutes. Didn't happen yet.
G6.
Solo Mexico, her voice soars above a sweet Spanish guitar. And I got a bit like Dr. Pepper, originality made her a star. The taste of Dr. Pepper, the taste of originality, salutes individuality and gives life a personality. Be you, do what you do. Be you.
Create your own holiday feast at Red Lobster. Combine two or three of your seafood favorites from 11 signature dishes, including our tender snow crab. Turn a meal into a celebration at Red Lobster.
Honey, wake up! Time for presents!
This holiday, show her how excited you are about her with a beautiful gift of gold from Kay Jewelers, because gold is the one language everyone understands.
Wow!
Every kiss begins with K.
Time for an SEC Championship Diamond Moment presented by K Jewelers. 1998, trailing in the fourth quarter against Mississippi State, T. Martin found Peerless Price for a 41-yard touchdown to put the Vols up by three. The Bulldogs fumbled on the next possession. Then on the very next play, it was T. Martin again throwing 26 yards for Cedric Wilson and another score. The Vols celebrated their second straight SEC title on their way to a victory in the Fiesta Bowl and a national championship.
Well, we're back in Atlanta. Let's go to the Big 12. Here's Todd Blackledge's Tim Brando.
Well, Vern, a lot of AP voters watching this game as well as ours. And Jason White, 22 yards to his favorite target, Mark Clayton. Oklahoma, 14-0 over the Buffaloes. Back to you, Vern.
No fly in the ointment with that one earlier today. So you did that very, very well. Scarily well. 29-24, Southern Cal win. Brett Smith, who dropped that potential big, big pass. Thinking about that right now. Ball on the 13. First down and 10. Cadillac Williams out to the 18-yard line. And let's go down once again to Tracy Wolfson. Trace.
Thanks, Vern. You talked about Brett Smith dropping that pass. A lot of helmets flying in frustration on this Tennessee sideline, specifically Brett Smith. Rick Clawson trying to keep his guys positive. Gerald Riggs running up and down saying, keep your head in the game.
All right, Tracy, thank you. And pictures do tell a big story, don't they?
A lot of football left. And that guy has made a lot of big plays catching the football for this Tennessee offense this year. So no reason to get down at this point. Everybody drops ball.
Second down and four. Here's Campbell on the keeper. After the
fumble. Yep, that's a fumble.
Turk McBride, number 90. This is not an Auburn team that gives it up a lot. They were plus six in turnovers coming in. That's only the eighth fumble they've lost all season long.
Well, we said Jason Campbell has not run the ball much this season, and we've seen him run more tonight than we've seen all year. Again, a designed quarterback run. And I think Mahalona was there first, and Kevin Burnett is the guy who made the hit that knocked the ball loose, and Turk McBride came up with it. Burnett with a big hit right on the football, and Turk McBride has Tennessee right back in the red zone.
Ball at the 20. They went 14 for their only touchdown of the ball game. That followed a bobbled snap. So three turnovers by Auburn tonight. Here's the first down rumble, and it's inside the 15-yard line. Cedric Houston, number 21.
I made this point earlier on the touchdown run that got called back. We've seen Tennessee now fake this reverse, and the reason you do that is because that reverse is going to hold these defenders just a little bit and allow you to run the ball inside. Watch the fake reverse affect the outside defenders for Auburn. It holds them just an instant and keeps them away from the play.
Second down and five. Jason Swain is wide to the right. C.J. Faton split off to the left. And a little confusion now. Anderson gets the play. Two on the play clock. And they get the snap. There's Houston coming left, and he is stiffened. Travis Williams, number 51, was the first man there. And then T.J. Jackson, number 58, was also a part of the tackle.
I know Tennessee prides themselves on being tough and always being able to run the football. And they did have the long run called back, but this is the best run defensive football team in the conference. Coming into tonight's game, Auburn only allowing 95 yards a game rushing. And they shut down Tennessee in the first half running the football, but Tennessee coming out with a couple different looks here in the second half has hit a couple runs on them.
Hannon split off wide right on third down. That's the tight end, Chris Brown. Here's Clawson with a play fake. Looking for Hannon all the way in the end zone.
Justin Reed, what a catch.
Whoa, it's Reed.
Oh, there's a late flag, too. A very late flag.
Reed, the tight end.
This, well, I don't know what this is. I'm not even going to speculate. Unless, you know what this is? This is an illegal lineman downfield. Albert Tawina was way downfield when this ball was thrown.
Yep. There it is.
And that's going to negate a tremendous effort by both Rick Clawson and particularly Justin Reed.
Now think about this. We played just a second more than 5 minutes.
Number 72 of the offense was illegally downfield in the pass. 5-yard penalty, repeat third down.
And Philip Fulmer saying as they went to the locker room, if in the 5 minutes, yeah. They've had a touchdown of 70 yards wiped out. They had a drop pass from Brett Smith, and now this.
Well, here's Tuina right here. And even though it's a bootleg, he's still got to stay behind. He ends up way down here. I mean, he just he got discombobulated and started going downfield looking for a block. And that wiped out the play.
On third and eight, here's Clawson. He's got a man open. Man. Caught, touchdown. Robert Meacham.
They got it on Carlos Rogers, too. The best cover corner on the team. They really fooled him on that one. I don't think they were expecting Tennessee to throw right there. And they went right at Carlos Rogers.
Casey Clawson with the applause. Rick Clawson's dad, Jim, very quiet. Had a certain degree of equanimity. And his daughter, Katie, just to his right. Mom, Kathy, is also a part of it. The whole family from Thousand Oaks, California. His son, Rick. And this one from Will Hoyt is up and good. And Robert Meacham, who had a huge game against Kentucky with 5 catches for 143 yards, gets the touchdown and cuts the margin to 7.
And say something about the mental toughness of this Tennessee football team to overcome the penalties, to overcome what looked like missed opportunities. All of a sudden, it's a 7-point game.
It strikes me that it's a good thing there's not instant replay. Did you see that ball? It may have hit the ground.
Are those tofu dogs done yet?
Is it done?
Man, I hope not.
Diet doesn't have to taste like diet. With Diet Dr. Pepper, you sacrifice nothing. Diet Dr. Pepper tastes more like regular Dr. Pepper.
Stronger denim. More comfortable. Relaxed fit. Wrangler 5-star premium quality denim. Wrangler. Real comfortable jeans.
Sweet ride.
Yeah.
That was amazing. Let's do it.
Tired of waiting for your reward? With Thank You from Citi, you get great rewards that are easy to earn, easy to redeem. That's a card you can count on.
Hey, Herman, what's that?
It's a server.
A server?
An on-demand IBM e-server. It can monitor itself, manage itself, optimize itself, protect itself, practically heal itself.
How'd it get here?
Maybe it ordered itself.
Self-optimizing IBM eServer X Series with Intel Xeon processors.
As we search for ways to go, every day we should grow. Knowing is beautiful.
CBS Sports coverage of the SEC Championship Game, presented by Dr. Pepper, is sponsored by Diet Dr. Pepper. Thank you from Citi, the Home Depot, and by Pontiac.
Georgia Dome in Atlanta, sellout of 74,000 plus. Tennessee cuts the margin to 7. Robert Meacham, and the catch made very close to the ground. Take another look at just a moment. Now Will Hoyt will kick off. Cadillac Williams and Devin Aromashadu are deep. This one returnable. Williams at the 1. Oh boy. Cut down at the 13-yard line by Casey Larkins, a one-time running back. Corey Larkins, beg your pardon.
Let's go back and look at the touchdown catch by Meacham on the post route. Now he's going to come from this part of the field, but the key is Will Herring, the safety, gets caught hung up in here looking at the quarterback, Rick Clawson, and doesn't help on the post route. He's late to make any kind of a move. That left a wide open Meacham, and it was a low throw, But I think Meacham got his arm underneath the ball quickly because there was no bounce or bobble when he came up with it.
First down, here's Campbell, fakes the draw play, comes right side, man wide open, it's Courtney Taylor again. And they get Hefney again.
Boy, has he been a clutch receiver for this team all season. I mean, the vast majority of his catches have gone for first downs. He's had a number of them on critical third down situations, a couple on fourth down. And Jason Campbell, to try to quiet this tide of momentum, comes right out and makes a big throw on first down.
Taylor had the great catch, the 56-yarder on the first play of the ball game. That's his fourth catch for 104 yards in this game. 19 on that play. Play fake, Campbell, right side, tight end. That's Cooper Wallace, the tight end, and Hefney makes the tackle. 9 minutes to go, 21-14.
Nine minutes in the third quarter. I mean, we still we got a lot of football left to play. And, boy, I'm just impressed with Tennessee, you know, overcoming those mistakes their first possession and having the big long touchdown run called back and to get another big turnover and then capitalize. Their two touchdown drives have been for 14 and 19 yards, so they've taken advantage of the Auburn mistakes.
Shovel play, it was covered. Here's Campbell being chased and run out of bounds just shy of the 40-yard line. And let's go down to Tracy Wolfson.
Vernon defensive tackle Jesse Mahalona is out right now because of cramping. Trainers say they're giving him tons of salt and tons of Gatorade to try and prevent those cramps. They do expect him to return, though.
All right, thank you, Tracy. Three tackles tonight. He'll look on now as his defensive teammates confront an Auburn team that looks at a third and three. They've been all but unstoppable on third and five or less.
Tennessee looks really confused on this defensive set. They got guys pointing all over the place.
Campbell half roll to his right. Now he's chased and he has to throw it away.
Oh, a late hit on Paris Harrelson, or a hit to the head. I mean, Campbell is throwing the ball away, and they're saying Harrelson hit him in the head. Totally unnecessary penalty because they had the play defended and stopped and would have gotten the football. Boy, have penalties been crucial against Tennessee here to start the second half.
Personal foul, roughing the passer, number 98 on the defense. 15-yard penalty and automatic first down.
Remember, we saw these two guys jawing at each other early in the game. They're both Mississippi guys. And Harrelson, I mean, just run by him. The play's over. You know he's throwing it away. And he lowered his head and went right into the face of Jason Campbell. I mean, you got to make that call. I mean, the fans boo, but that's a no-brainer.
Penalties in this half. Four for 35. One of them wiped out a 70-yard touchdown run. That one wiped out what it would have been, a punt. And here's Campbell.
Omar Gaither, the first sack. But I'll tell you one thing. That's the first sack that Tennessee has gotten on Jason Campbell. But it is not the first time they've knocked him down. Now, he's run it a few times, so they've tackled him. But they've knocked him down after he's thrown the ball several times in this ballgame already. Omar Gaither right here, he's going to beat the block of Carnell Williams, just overpowers Carnell, and then throws him aside and gets the sack from the backside. Great individual effort by the linebacker, Omar Gaither.
Loss of five, second and 15 with 7.5 to go third quarter. Mahalona back on the field. Here comes a four-man rush. Williams comes right. Good pursuit defensively. It'll be third and 12.
Very good.
Hefney and Mitchell on that tackle.
And one thing that you're seeing, even though they've had a couple penalties, I think Tennessee is tackling better here so far in the third quarter. I mean, in that first half when they gave up over 300 yards, they had 16 missed tackles in the first half of play. They seem to be doing a much better job so far in the second half of tackling the guy with the ball.
Third and 14, and Jason Campbell says to Steve Landis, We need a timeout. Tennessee trails, but only by a touchdown.
This holiday season, give that special someone on your list something they can't wait to use. Grab all your gifts and a tree to put them under. You can at the Home Depot. Hurry in. The exclusive Dremel 220-piece kit is now $29.99. A Ryobi 12-volt drill kit with stud sensor and 26-bit set is $59.97. Nobody has more know-how to help make your holiday dollars work harder. The Home Depot. You can do it. We can help.
Ever G6.
Introducing the new char-grilled chicken sandwich from Chick-fil-A, rebuilt from the wheat bun up. Add a refreshing Dasani water, and it's this year's biggest splash.
A former state trooper finds his wife and kids murdered. Which clues will you believe? 11 eyewitnesses or 8 drops of blood? A 48 hours mystery tonight.
Unusual reason for the Auburn timeout. Back on the roughing the passer penalty. Campbell lost the list of plays that he wears on his left wrist. Didn't realize it till he looked down at the line of scrimmage.
See, there's a little piece of paper right there that's flying out of that wristband, and that's when he went to look at it on that third down play. He said, wait a minute, I don't have the plays here.
So he got the thing back, and now on 3rd and 14, Campbell is back. Fires for the short receiver, and that's a Roma Shadu and a three-man gang tackle led by Jason Allen.
And there's going to be a holding on Auburn as well, right in the middle of that pocket, which Tennessee will probably decline at this point and make them punt the football.
Yep. The LaFormer says, let's take a look at Cody
67
Bliss.
On the offense. Penalty is declined. Fourth down.
That's Jeremy Engle. And so Cody Bliss is going to come on. Bliss, who had a 15-yard punt, his first and only timeout. The second time he fumbled the snap, that led to a 14-yard touchdown. So I'm sure hopes of redemption running through his head right now.
Well, the first thing is to catch it.
Yes.
You don't have to kick it very far in this situation, but you better catch it.
Here's the punt. Fair catch called. It'll let the ball bounce into the end zone. It'll come out to the 20-yard line.
Been impressed so far here in the third quarter with the Tennessee defensive front. They have kind of taken the game to this very good Auburn offensive line here to start the third quarter.
I'd like my hard drive to fry like a mozzarella stick.
I'd like all our family photos to just disappear.
I'd like catastrophic system failure.
Millions of Americans are just asking for a computer virus because they're not nearly as protected as they think they are.
No, it'd be awesome if my computer could make the sound of a Yeti.
That's why America Online now gives away virus protection to all our members. Absolutely free.
That's what I want.
Want a better internet? You belong at America Online.
You ready for the woo! Hurricane?
This Tuesday, the year's most in-your-face comedy.
I love you.
Joni loves Chachi.
We'll make you laugh till you cry.
You're going to dodge the wrench, you're going to dodge the ball.
Dodgeball. Grab it Tuesday.
Perfect.
Create your own holiday feast at Red Lobster. Combine two or three of your seafood favorites from 11 signature dishes, including our tender snow crab. Turn a meal into a celebration at Red Lobster.
Thursday.
Go!
The ultimate winner of this challenge ends up in the final four. Guaranteed. A new Survivor Thursday and the season finale CBS Sunday.
Big 12 championship. Once again, Todd Blackledge as Tim Brendo.
Burn, can you say deja vu? Because it's Jason White to Mark Clayton again for 22 yards and another touchdown. Jason White, 9 of 10, 106 yards, 3 touchdowns. A couple of quarterbacks named Jason looking pretty good tonight.
Timmy B only thinks he's got a plane going home. First down and 10. And they hand it off, and here goes Riggs.
Oh, my goodness.
Gerald Riggs, 80 yards, touchdown, Tennessee.
And I'm not sure, but that might have been the same play that got called back because they faked the reverse again, which opened up the cutback lane, and Riggs busted it out the backside and took it all the way.
Wow. Trooper Taylor, the running back's coach, embracing Gerald Riggs. Houston went 70. It was called back for a holding call. Riggs goes 80, and Tennessee is within a try of tying it up. Will Hoyt had one blocked last week. This one is perfect.
Talk about the faking of the reverse. What does that do to the defense? Watch when this reverse comes around. The safety, Will Herring, gets affected by it. So when Riggs cuts it back, Herring is not in a good position to make the tackle. It starts on the one side. Herring is affected by the reverse, and Riggs busts it out the backside and takes it all the way to the end zone. That safety is unblocked. But if he doesn't make the tackle, you give up a big play.
What a turnaround. We're tied at 21.
That for the kids?
Yeah, I just got them some sweaters.
I just got us all on the Verizon Wireless Family Share Plan with M. That way they can talk to their friends all they want. Good luck with that.
Good luck with this.
Sign up for the Family Share Plan and the whole family can make unlimited in-calls to each other and any other Verizon Wireless customer from within the America's Choice coverage area. Plus, buy one LG VX3200 for $19.99 and get up to three free.
Thanks, Mom.
Thanks, Mom.
Verizon Wireless, we never stop working for you.
This is your market. It's your money. Your hopes. Your dreams. Your future. Our goal is to provide the fairest, most liquid market with new ways to trade, a commitment to unsurpassed quality, and the best price. So no matter who you are or how you invest, we're invested in you. The New York Stock Exchange.
From Tony and Ridley Scott, the directors of Hollywood's breakthrough movies, comes a new dramatic series, Numbers, coming in January to CBS.
Sense of accomplishment on the Tennessee bench. Gerald Riggs Jr., of course, his dad, long time great player in the NFL. 111 tonight, 80 came on the last scamper, and it's 21 all.
Tennessee had 12 yards rushing in the first half, and they have 130 so far in this half. So some very nice adjustments by Randy Sanders and the offensive coaches in that Tennessee locker room.
And they had a 70-yard run wiped out by a holding call.
That is right.
Cadillac Williams, one of two men deep for Auburn. Aroma Shadu is also back there. Will Hoyt will kick off.
Well, Tommy Tuberville has talked all year about his senior leaders and the leadership they provided. Now is when this team really needs to lean on those guys. Jason Campbell, Carnell Williams, Ronnie Brown. Those guys have to step up in this possession and make some plays.
Here's the kick. Cadillac Williams at the 1 yard line. Great special teams pursuit by Tennessee.
We're going to show you a couple plays. The first one we're going to show is the 70-yard run that was called back. This was Cedric Houston right out of the box in the third quarter. Same play. They start it to the strong side. They break it back. The safety misses the tackle, and he's affected by the fake of the reverse. This one didn't count. It was called back. Then moments ago, same play. Started strong, fake the reverse, safety out of position, and the running back takes it out the backside all the way to the end zone. The same play, one counted, the other one didn't.
11-0, Auburn has not given up 21 points this season in a game until tonight. Previous high was 14. And again, the Volunteer defense led by Omar Gaither and Jason Mitchell there to make the stop.
And it's the defensive line. I mean, the Tennessee defensive line has taken control of the game here in the third quarter. They have been more physical than that Auburn offensive line. They've gotten penetration. They've held their ground, and that's allowed these linebackers to fly to the football.
Arkansas did get 20 in a game that was won by Auburn 38-20. So 21 is the new season high. Campbell dropped. Silas Daniels.
And that's one of those seniors, Silas Daniels, that you expect to stay calm and make a play. Just kind of lost his focus and concentration. Started to run before he caught it. You see that head turn to the right? He was looking to take off before he secured the catch. Third and 10 now for Auburn. And through the year, they've been very good on third and long yardage situations. But this Tennessee defense, extremely revved up right now.
Tennessee brings four. Campbell steps up, has a man down the middle. It's caught by Ronnie Brown. First down, Auburn.
And that's just a nice job of Jason Campbell feeling the rush and stepping up in the pocket, but not losing his vision downfield and picking up somebody that could make a play for him. Ronnie Brown is coming out right here, and he's going to run a little route like this, but Jason Campbell has to step up in the pocket. Watch his presence in the pocket. Burnett forces him up. He never loses his vision downfield and finds Ronnie Brown for a much-needed first down.
Brown with 19 rushing yards, 55 receiving on six catches. And the play clock down to three. Brown, Jesse Mahalona, yep.
And Jeremy Engel, the center, who is bothered by a bad ankle, is down. Jesse Mahalona is right over the center. Here he is right here. Watch him just blow right through Jeremy Engel. Knocks him back, gets the penetration, gets the tackle, and Engel is still down with a bad ankle coming in. Now remember, Stephen Ross, who's the backup center, he injured his knee a couple weeks ago. He's out for the season, so they're going to have to do some moving around. Probably Danny Lindsay, the right guard, will have to move back into that center spot.
Time called while they tend to Jeremy Engel.
I'll just have a Coke.
I'll have a chocolate cherry grape Coke, please.
A what? Breakfast time.
I like getting my taste buds up and running. Morning, gents.
Yeah.
Here's a little chocolate. Here's a little cherry. Here's a little grape, and then you got some cola in there too. Deal with it, and I'll see you at lunch.
Right.
Your favorite flavors. Sonic's got them. Others don't. Start your day right and make Sonic your morning drink stop. It's not just good. It's Sonic good.
Service?
Covered.
Gesundheit. NyQuil. You sleep great. Sleep like lumber.
What?
Like the infant.
Oh.
Sleep like home?
NyQuil, the nighttime sniffling, sneezing, coughing, aching, stuffy head, fever, best sleep you ever got with a cold medicine.
The NFL Today catches up with San Diego's quarterback, Drew Brees, and with New England's running back, Corey Dillon. The show that's always ahead of the game. The NFL Today, Sunday on CBS.
Jeremy Engle trying to walk off that ankle injury. And while he stays out, Danny Lindsay, a moment ago, last year's starting center, was the right guard all of this year, practicing snapping the ball to Jason Campbell.
Yeah, that's why this isn't nearly as bad of a problem as it might be for some teams, because the guy that's in there now was a center all year last year.
Second down and 12. Here's Campbell. Again, forced right. Chased by Harrelson. Fires to Courtney Taylor. And the catch is made at the 33-yard line.
Yeah, didn't gain much, though. Last time we saw this Auburn team, Alabama had stuffed the run in the first half. And they came out of the locker room, Auburn did, and said, Jason, we're going to have to throw the football. We're going to have to put the ball in your hands. And he responded terrifically in that game. And down the stretch against Georgia and Alabama, Jason Campbell made a lot of big plays. And particularly in that Alabama game, he basically put the team on his back in that second half and won the game.
Well, John Chavis indicated to you, the defensive coordinator, he thought he wanted to put this game in Jason Campbell's hands and force Campbell to beat Tennessee.
And the thing they've been able to do is they've been able to put him under some duress. They have been able to knock him around a little bit.
Here's the pass, and it's dropped. It's contact.
Yeah.
Rashawn Fellows, and this might be interference.
Yeah, and again, coming into the ball game, this Tennessee defense, with two freshmen playing at corner, with a lot of problems, they've had three or four different starters at strong safety. Their free safety is a guy who really should be playing corner, Jason Allen. They're last in the SEC in pass defense. And they've given
that's
up a lot of big
by
plays.
The defense, number 36. Billy is less
and
than
a lot of times,
yards, so the ball will be placed in the spot of the foul. First
you know, when you're struggling, you play a little tentative and you make a lot of mistakes. And that's Rashawn Fellows. The contact was early, and that's why the penalty occurred. He was in pretty decent position to make a play on the ball, but he made early contact.
Penalty results in a first down at the 47. Here's Campbell back, deep right side. Aroma Shadu is wide open. And Aroma Shadu strolls in for an Auburn touchdown.
Same guy, Rashawn Fellows, who is probably upset that he just got the penalty on him. They went right after him again, and this time it was even worse. He gave up the touchdown.
Devin Aroma Shadu, who had that huge game, the back-breaking play in the come-from-behind win at Alabama, gets the touchdown from 53 yards out.
Well, I like that call. You know, you got a guy, a young corner. He just got called for pass interference. He's still thinking about that, and you go right after him for the big one.
John Vaughn's extra point is up and good. .345 to go in the third. In the 2004 SEC Championship, Auburn leads again by 7.
We're part of Tennessee on the Move. We're nutrition majors and research assistants at the University of Tennessee. We're part of a program that helps people live healthier lives. Basically, it's about walking more, eating less, and getting your calcium. Research at UT shows that including just 3 or 4 servings of dairy food in your diet each day actually helps you lose weight. It's rewarding to be a part of a national initiative like Tennessee on the Move. We're helping to change lives.
Since its launch in 2002, the SEC's Education Initiative has grown to reach over 1.5 million children, with over 2,000 schools utilizing this interactive software as part of their daily curriculum.
Students love it, and research proves that it will increase test scores. Every school should be using Kids College.
Motivation is a key to learning, and SEC Kids College is a proven success. The Universities of the Southeastern Conference, equipping tomorrow's leaders today.
Two cities, two CSI teams, too big to miss.
I am going to find this man.
CSI Miami in New York, CBS Monday.
Auburn goes back on top 28-21. Jason Campbell with a 53-yard pass. And he has surpassed 300 yards for the first time in his splendid career as the Auburn quarterback.
And look at the percentage of completion. 24 of 31. Coming into the game, almost 70% completion. He's been so accurate all season. And even on the deep balls, very accurate. That was a beautiful throw there.
Philip Yost will kick off as the Auburn Tigers try and finish a perfect season or continue a perfect season. There's a bowl game in their future. Riggs comes out to the 20.
Well, let's go back to the touchdown. Now, Rashawn Fellows is the guy who's going to get his name in the paper, but watch the safety, Jason Allen, get too caught up in the run fake, and he's unable to recover and help the corner. You want your safety to be able to help on this route, but he's so far behind because he hung around looking at the run fake that Fellows had no help from the inside, and Jason Campbell found a Roma Shadu with a nice throw. I mean, that's Rashawn Fellows got beat, but he's got to expect to have a little help from Jason Allen on that play as well.
First down and 10. Clawson with a play fake. Three set up. He goes deep right side. It's just beyond the reach of Chris Hannon. Well, among the teams ranked 1, 2, and 3 in the current BCS standings, Southern Cal, tough game against UCLA. They won 29-24. Oklahoma rolling over Colorado 28-0. Tommy Tuberville's team, as a flag is down, has a 7-point lead here. And this is a look at the current BCS championship standings.
Well, you see that Oklahoma rolling. Remember last year, that was what created so much of the controversy at the end of the year with USC, LSU, and Oklahoma. Oklahoma had dominated everybody all year, and they got in the Big 12 championship game and got waxed by Kansas State. I'm sure those guys remember that going into this year's game. An eligible man downfield. That's the second time we've had that call.
Number 87 of the offense was illegally downfield. He was covered up but went downfield on the pass route. That's a 5-yard penalty. Repeat first down.
Justin Reed is a tight end, which he, you know, you'd say, well, a tight end should be able to go downfield. But if he's covered by an outside receiver, that makes him ineligible. And that was the case in that particular formation. Now, whether it was Justin Reed's fault for going downfield or if it was the receiver's fault for lining up incorrectly, I'm not sure.
First and 15. Cedric Houston is the running back. Corey Anderson, the fullback.
Left tackle moved. Aaron Sears moved forward in his stance, and they're going to go back five more.
Aaron Sears, whose brother Kevin Sears is just opposite him, wearing number 40 in the white.
For the snap, 76 for the offense, false start, 5-yard penalty, still first down.
That is the 10th penalty against Tennessee. Well, since 2000, read this, in 2000, Florida State, one loss. Got a spot ahead of one-loss Miami, 2001. And then, who can forget last year when USC, top-ranked in both polls, did not get a spot in the Sugar Bowl, even after Oklahoma lost to Kansas State. On first down, here's the handoff. Running play doesn't garner much out to the 13-yard line.
You know, just one more comment on that BCS thing. I actually thought what happened last year was not so bad. I mean, the other scenarios I thought were bad, but the fact that we had two national champions last year in a split championship, I thought that was okay because I thought all three teams deserved to play for a national championship last year, and they all three got that opportunity. And the fact that it was split, I don't have a problem with that. Now this year, you know, we may not have that same situation if all three finish undefeated.
Second down and 17. Fossing the time, deep down the middle, double coverage. Meacham is down there.
Beautiful throw.
Robert Meacham, great catch. Huge huge play.
And it's Carlos Rogers again. And Will Herring, who has just not been able to make any plays from his safety position. Now there is a penalty down.
It's going to come back.
Oh, it looks like holding. When you see offensive linemen drop their head and walk backwards, it's not good. What a great throw by Rick Clawson, though. My goodness, this was a pretty throw.
And that will wipe out a 45-yard
holding
game.
Holding number 74 on the offense, half the distance to the goal. Repeat second down.
Gandy, he's playing the tackle position out here. He's in for Tuina, and he's holding on Brett Edens. He got that arm around him, but what a throw by Rick Clawson. And he's saying, Steve, don't you know how hard that is to throw in bracket coverage and beat Carlos Rogers on a deep ball? I may never throw another one like that again the rest of the game.
Well, Tennessee continues a case of here's my foot, I think I'll shoot it. Another penalty. And this catch made by Anderson short at the 13-yard line. And it will result in a third down. And huge. They've had a 70-yard touchdown run wiped out. And they've now had a 45-yard pass completion wiped out.
Well, right now, Rick Clawson, who has played much better here in the second half than he did in the first half, has to be very, very careful. Third down and very long against this fast Auburn defense. Get something if you can and let Dustin Colquitt come in and try to make a good punt.
Clawson comes deep near side, and that one's going to be out of bounds. Catch made by Brett Smith, but he was in the Auburn bench.
This throw was thrown a little bit too far out. Brett Smith, who had a drop earlier, gives a great effort on that one, just about 4 yards outside the field of play.
Here's Colquitt, who has had an excellent night.
I just would have liked to have seen him got about a 10-yard completion there and give Colquitt a little bit more room so that he wasn't kicking out of his own end zone.
Cadillac Williams hasn't had much to return tonight. He goes over and he will be able to, well, no, it's going to bounce and come backwards.
Now that's one of the problems when you try to directional kick and you try to kick away from a player. Sometimes you don't get as good of a kick as you'd like to.
Now let's go down to Tracy Wilson for this SEC moment presented by Sonic.
Thanks, Vern. The year was 1957, and Auburn began its season with a 7-0 victory over rival Tennessee. 3 months later, the Tigers were 10-0 and SEC champs and proclaimed national champs by the AP poll. Jimmy Red Phillips was an All-American wide receiver for those Tigers, and last night he was honored as part of the SEC Legends Class of 2004.
And what a great night that was, Tracy.
Yeah.
Jimmy Phillips, Dan Reeves from South Carolina, George Blanda from Kentucky.
How about that? Wasn't that something?
It was a wonderful night as 12 legends were honored. Here's Ronnie Brown as he goes left. Tennessee legend was Frank Emmanuel, outstanding linebacker from the 60s.
I think for the most part, Tennessee defensively tonight has come in saying, all right, we are going to really focus on shutting down Carnell Williams and Ronnie Brown, and they have done an outstanding job. The only problem is the same guy that beat him up in Knoxville in October is beating him again here tonight, Jason Campbell, with a career night.
Second down and four, handoff, right side. That's Ronnie Brown, number 23. We mentioned in the first half that Cadillac Williams committed to Tennessee. So also did Ronnie Brown. Yeah. He's a young man from the middle of Georgia. And he initially said he was going to go to Knoxville. Changed his mind and enrolled with the Auburn Tigers. Yeah. Yesterday, we've got to know these young men very well over the years.
Mm-hmm.
And so yesterday, making reintroductions, Ronnie Brown said, hi, I'm Cadillac. And Cadillac said, hi, I'm Ronnie Brown.
Oh, you were right. I mean, that. You were their guy, man. Carnell had his arm around you and laughing with you.
Well, he's got an appreciation for a man approaching senility. There's Ronnie Brown. We were talking with them about there were five seniors that we had a chat with yesterday at the walkthrough, and Cadillac Williams disagreed with the other four teammates, all of whom said the key game for them was LSU this year. And for a moment, we thought he was pulling our leg. He said he thought the key game was the Citadel. And his point, I think, was that they really concentrated and played well in that game. At least I hope that was his point.
They didn't take the week off.
Well, we've reached the end of three, and the score 28-21. We'll return to the Georgia Dome right after these messages and this word from your local station.
CBS 4 is your local news station.
A Lawrence firefighter and a dispatcher drinking and snorting cocaine on duty.
Tonight, a child rapist is on the run.
For a while today, we saw 50, 60 mile an hour gusts, troubling side effects to a relatively new anti-aging treatment.
CBS 4 is your local news station.
The 2005 Toyota Corolla takes whatever you dish out, day after day, year after year after year. Can Corolla make a lasting impression on you? Ask someone you know who drives one.
Happy holidays
from all of us at CBS 4.
It's my game.
My picture.
It's my movies.
My favorite TV shows.
Panasonic introduces the only DVD recorder with a hard drive that stores up to 700 hours of your favorite stuff and saves it all on DVD.
It's my home video.
It's my vacation. It's gotta be my game.
These are my TV shows.
Your life.
Wow.
Now available on DVD. Panasonic. Ideas for life.
Winterland! Winterland is a heartwarming family experience featuring millions of lights and breathtaking seasonal delights. An enchanting winter wonderland for children and adults alike. Winterland is open every evening beginning November 26th and is located in the heart of Neshoba Valley Ski Area, just off Route 495 in Westford, Mass. Log on to www.visitwinterland.com or call our festival line at 1-800-400-SNOW. Be sure to visit your local iParty and Papa Gino's for valuable discount coupons.
This is CBS 4.
Heads up! Heads up! Here's another one. And another one. Heads up! Heads up!
Rick Clawson led the Tennessee Volunteers back from a 14-point deficit. They tied it up at 21-all, but then Jason Campbell struck with a 53-yard pass to Aroma Shadu, and Auburn leads it now 28-21 as we begin the final quarter with the ball on the 27 and the Tigers second down and three. Courtney Taylor starts in motion. Here's the toss sweep. Jake Slaughter leads the way, and Ronnie Brown is spilled inside the 24. That'll be close for a first down. Well, it was really an extraordinary come from behind for this Tennessee team.
Well, it really was. I mean, they fought their way back in. They got a couple breaks in the first half, which gave them a chance, and then they came right out. And I'm so impressed with how they hung in there after they had the long touchdown run called back. They had a couple penalties that really went against them, but they hung in there and they found a way to make some plays. But again, now we're seeing that senior leadership at Auburn and Jason Campbell, who has played so brilliantly all season, but particularly against this Tennessee football team, both up in Knoxville and here again tonight in the Georgia Dome, has kind of taken over the game.
Well, here is the stretch of the chain, and it is, that's a little longer than a smidgen. Well, Campbell, the first game against Tennessee, he threw for 255 yards, most of that in the first half. And tonight, career game, 319. Two touchdowns, one interception.
You know, and I'm reminded of what Al Borges told us, that he told Jason in some of those tight games this year, like in LSU or in Alabama. He says, you know, this is the kind of game when you really find out how good of a quarterback you are. Not when you're winning by 30 and you're throwing three and four touchdowns. It's a game like this when they stop the run a little bit and they force you to make plays. and he has stepped up.
Got a push from behind by one of his teammates, and that might have been enough to give Auburn a first down. Now let's take another look at that long toss to Aroma Shadu.
And let's watch it in the slow motion again, our new little feature on the game tonight. Good play action fake. And then just watch the beautiful arc on the football. And again, Jason Campbell has thrown the deep ball so well this year. I mean, his average yards per pass attempt coming into the game was almost 10 yards, which is very high. And he's hit some big ones here, some long down the field throws in the ball game tonight as well.
First down and 10. Campbell did get enough for the first down. And the play clock is down to 2-1. Got it. The handoff goes right. Ronnie Brown, number 23. The Jason Campbell passing chart for the evening.
Again, you can see just about every square except for this one. It's like the Hollywood squares. The only one up there, Paul Lynn Square, was not used. Everywhere else, he's thrown the ball and had some success.
Paul Lind?
Yeah, he was the funny guy, wasn't
oh,
he?
He gosh, was
usually
yes,
in the middle,
was.
Though. He was usually in the middle square.
But he was a guy my age. I'm stunned.
I liked him.
That's good. I'll get you a spot on Jeopardy, perhaps. Here's Campbell. Heading left. Blocked from behind. Campbell hangs on to it. Oh, he got a good block back behind the line of scrimmage, but Campbell is hurt.
Now, again, they have hit him tonight, the Tennessee defense. And when he leaves the pocket, you know, he's free game. They've knocked him down after he's thrown, but he's run the ball how many times now? About 8 or 9 times he's run the football. In fact, in the first half, he was the leading rusher for Auburn. Now he's carried the ball 11 times, 12 times for 59 yards. Once he leaves the pocket, I mean, everybody wants to try to take a shot, and that's Justin Harrell on the top, landing on top of him. That's about a 300-pound defensive lineman hitting him.
First down. Here's the toss. Watch out. Here's Ronnie Brown. Left-handed throw for Aroma Shadu.
Good play.
And it is incomplete.
Good play by Jason Allen. He was not fooled. Of course, we saw that one happen in the Georgia game. We saw Carnell Williams throw it to Anthony Mix for a touchdown. This time they go with Ronnie Brown. But watch Jason Allen. He's reading in the backfield. He doesn't bite on the fake. He stays deep with the receiver, and he's in perfect position to make a play.
Second down and 10. Ball just inside the 12-yard line. 28-21, 12:45 to go. The 2004 Southeastern Conference Championship. Carnell Williams back is the deep back in the eye. Jake Slaughter is the fullback. Comes the run blitz. They hand it to Cadillac. He's down at the 5-yard line.
Boy, nice play, though. I mean, if that would have been a pass play, it would have probably been a sack. As it turned out, Jesse Mahalona ran right by the play, and Cadillac Williams took it the other way.
I'm just thinking back to the open of our broadcast tonight with Peyton Manning and Bo Jackson, and Jackson sitting in the locker room talking about, look at the two guys we got back here. Cadillac Williams and H2, the Hummer, Ronnie Brown. And then there's the quarterback named Campbell. They're pretty good. Third down. Blitz is coming. Campbell darts to his left, goes deep, overthrows Courtney Taylor. It's incomplete. It'll be fourth down. That was Hefney defending and doing a good job.
Well, pretty good stop that time by Tennessee. They've given up some yardage. They've given up some plays, but giving up 3 here, much better than giving up another 7 with 11:50 left in the ballgame. John Vaughn, who is 8 of 11 on the season.
Alex Howell will hold it. This from 22 yards out. Cuts it nicely and adds 3 to the total for the Auburn Tigers. Eleven 36 to go. 31-21, Auburn.
Now, it's time for the block of the day, presented by Earthlink.
On Carnell Williams' five-yard touchdown, some excellent blocks, three, in fact, on this well-executed play. Watch the wide receiver Ben Obamanu come in, the Anthony Mix, the tight end, and the big block, Marcus McNeil, the left tackle, clears out the way for Carnell Williams. All three guys in perfect position. McNeil with the monster block on the outside, and then Carnell Williams does the rest. The Earthlink block of the day, big Marcus McNeil.
For more on Earthlink's block of the day, log on to cbssportsline.com/earthlink.
As a proud Earthlink employee, I swear I'll do my part to help protect you from bad internet.
I promise to hate pop-up ads as much as you do.
And I promise we won't rest until your inbox is free of spam emails like Hot Girls Want You and Why Be Bald.
We're going to help you. We're going to take your problem and treat it like it's our problem, and we're going to work it until it's solved.
I promise. I promise.
More access options, free blocking tools. That's better internet. Earthlink revolves around you.
Introducing the new char-grilled chicken sandwich from Chick-fil-A. Rebuilt from the wheat bun up. Add a refreshing Dasani water, and it's this year's biggest splash.
All Frank Griffin wants for Christmas is his wife back.
Homewrecker!
You gotta learn to deal.
I know.
Joe Mantegna and Gene Smart, A Very Merry Christmas, CBS Sunday.
Tomorrow, the NFL Today features a couple of difference makers. Shannon Sharp visits with the Pats' Corey Dillon. And Marcus Allen profiles the Chargers' comeback kid, Drew Brees. And when Bob Dillon sits down for his first television interview in 19 years, you've got to hear what he's got to say Sunday on 60 Minutes.
I don't know if you'll understand it. I used to listen to some of his music, never understood anything he said. I never knew what he was singing.
Well, you were listening to Paul Lind.
I like Paul Lind. He was funny.
This is great. I get two Tim Brandos tonight and a Bob Dylan. And I am so happy that Steve Spurrier is back in the conference for any number of reasons, not the least of which is hearing you do your dead-on impression of him.
Well, hopefully early next September in Athens, Georgia, I'll be doing my impersonation.
South Carolina will play at the University of Georgia on September 10th.
That'll be his first SEC game again.
Yeah, the looks are a little longer, like the dreadlocks. First down and 10. Rick Clawson under Jason Respert, his center. 10-point game, 11:45 to go. The handoff, Riggs again. Big hole. There's Will Herring, who gets juked out of the way. Junior Rose Green saves the touchdown.
Now, Will Herring has had a good season this year as the starting free safety. He has not had a good night tonight for this Auburn defense. He has missed a lot of big tackles. Here's Herring right here. Again, good blocking by Tennessee. It's the counter trap. They bring the guard and the fullback again. Good block by the wide receiver. Now here's Herring, unblocked, and just can't make the tackle. And that ends up being about 15 to 20 more yards before Junior Rose Green can knock him out of bounds.
Gerald Rigg tacks a 54-yard run onto an earlier 80-yard touchdown walk. First down and 10 at the 26. Right side. This is Cedric Houston for a couple.
Outside zone play against an eight-man front. Auburn trying to drop a safety down late to get an extra guy in the run defense. You look at Gerald Riggs' night tonight. Career high, 165 yards. He was the guy who scored the winning touchdown last week against Kentucky. with 38 seconds left. He'd love to do that again tonight on a much bigger stage.
After the gain of 2, second and 8. Cross and play fake. Goes deep, man wide open, sliding catch, Tony Brown.
If he hits him in stride, he walks into the end zone. Rick Clawson does a good job of reading the coverage. It's only a two-man route. They kept both backs in and they released two receivers. And if he hits him on the move, Tony Brown turns that up and goes right to the corner of the end zone for 6.
See, he's had at least one reception in all 12 games. Now Swain and Brown go wide to the left. Fayton and Hannon are wide right.
They're just going to do a run here. Spread them out and try to run the football with Riggs.
Play fake instead. Into the end zone. He overthrows C.J. Fayton, number 17. Second down.
Thought there might have been a little push by Will Herring on that play. He was the guy in coverage. The ball was thrown high. Well, again, you got to admire the resolve of this Tennessee football team. And I talked to Philip Fulmer before the game, and he said, I think we're going to play well. I think our guys feel very challenged. Nobody's given them much of a chance in this ball game, and they have proved that they belong here in the second half particularly.
Here's Riggs, dances left. Touchdown, Tennessee. They do personify resiliency, don't they? The Volunteers are within 4. Second touchdown for Riggs. The 9-yarder complements the earlier effort of 80 yards. And here's Will Hoyt for the extra point. Snap a little high, but a fine hole by John Henderson. The kick is good. Tennessee back to within 3.
With Gerald Riggs, only 8 carries, but he's been effective. 174 yards and 2 touchdowns. And Tennessee back within 3.
B2K. Hear that Motown sound like Smokey Robinson found.
Come on.
Like Dr. Pepper. It's originality known worldwide.
The taste of Dr. Pepper. The taste of originality. Salutes individuality.
And gives life a personality.
Be you.
Do what you do.
Be you.
Nothing's better. Dr. Pepper.
Something smells good. Delivery?
It's not delivery. It's DiGiorno.
DiGiorno? Get out. You fix the oven. You fix the oven? You are handy. I'm calling mother.
Pizza?
Introducing DiGiorno Microwave Pizza. Rises up golden brown in minutes. For oven-baked taste in a hurry, it's not delivery. It's DiGiorno. Microwave.
Microwave, huh?
At least I fixed something.
Five-star relaxed fit premium quality denim. Wrangler. Real comfortable jeans.
CBS Sports coverage of the SEC Championship game presented by Dr. Pepper is sponsored by Dr. Pepper. Wrangler. Chick-fil-A. And by K Jewelers.
10:07 to go in the ball game, 31-28. Tennessee climbs back to within 3. Let's check the CBS Sportsline stat of the game. The 3 rushing touchdowns by the Volunteers tonight ties an SEC championship game record. That is the CBS Sportsline stat of the game. Get complete game stats at cbssportsline.com. Not only that, but keep in mind that this Auburn team had given up one rushing touchdown in 53 quarters coming into this ball game. And the run defense has been shredded, particularly in the second half by the Volunteers. Here's the kick. Cadillac Williams will take it. It'll be a touchback.
Let's go back and look at the touchdown and watch the block of the left tackle, Aaron Sears. He's going to get a block on McGlover. The guard and the fullback are going to pick up Didi, the linebacker. Now, I know his parents are going to think I'm picking on Will Herring. I'm really not. But again, he's going to be unblocked on this play, but unable to make the tackle on Riggs before Riggs can get to the end zone. And, you know, we should mention also, they run behind big Aaron Sears, and they've gotten some big plays running behind him. One guy we haven't even mentioned his name tonight, Michael Munoz,
right,
is not even here. He injured his shoulder in the Vanderbilt game, did not play last week, had surgery yesterday. And so Aaron Sears is in there at left tackle instead of the All-American, and they're running the ball well right now.
Here's Campbell with the play fake, steps up, lobs it. It's caught at the 25-yard line by Cadillac Williams, and Rashawn Fellows makes the stop. As a matter of fact, Michael Munoz, one of two from the SEC who will be honored at the National Football Foundation Hall of Fame dinner in New York on Tuesday night. And our congratulations to Michael Munoz and David Green, the Georgia quarterback. And Munoz, the son of Anthony Munoz, named first team in the Coaches All-America team. Fifth-year senior from Mason, Ohio. Second down and four. Campbell out of the spread. 31-28 with 9:24 to go. Campbell, designed quarterback draw, nothing doing. It's going to be third down.
And Omar Gaither came on a blitz on the outside and was just had a direct beat on that play. When you call that play, you're not expecting an outside blitz. And that time, Omar Gaither came in unblocked from the outside and stopped that play for very short yardage.
Third and five. 9 minutes to go. Three-point game.
I would say this is a very big conversion attempt for the Auburn offense. Look at that. 17 tackles for Omar Gaither. We thought we might see him at strong safety. John Javis has made a good decision to keep him at linebacker.
Brown in motion on third and five. Four-person rush. Here's the pass. Caught at the 30-yard line. That's going to be enough for a first down. Courtney Taylor again.
And again, he has been so effective on third down. And when they needed big catches, he knew what he needed for the first down. He got beyond the first down marker and then secured the catch.
That's six receptions for 111 yards tonight. Look at that, 26 first downs. And it's a three-point game. SEC championship game record, and here flags down.
Yeah, Turk McBride jumped off sides. Again, that's one of those cases where a defensive tackle who's lined up 6 inches from the football listens to the quarterback's voice instead of watching the football.
Fourth ball was snapped. Number 90 of the defense made contact. 5-yard penalty, still first down.
Well, how's Jason Campbell done tonight?
Not too bad. Career high, over 300 yards passing. He's run the ball very effectively. Now he's paid for it because he's gotten hit more tonight than I've ever seen him, but he has not lost his accuracy throwing the football.
Handoff. Bounce it outside as Cadillac Williams gets a good block from the tight end, Cooper Wallace, and he crosses the 50. Another first down. That's a gain of 16.
Well, Cadillac hasn't had a whole lot of open spaces to run through tonight, but he found one here. He gets away from Mahalona, who got penetration, and when he bounced it outside, he had a clean corner. He's not seen a lot of open green space in front of him tonight. The other thing right now that Auburn is doing is eating up
close.
Yes. I mean, they'd love to get more points, but it's just as important for them to eat time off the clock with this drive.
High formation, Williams behind Slaughter in the backfield. Oh, what a change of direction by Carnell Williams. Kevin Burnett makes the tackle, number two.
You know, if there's one big difference between Ronnie Brown and Carnell Williams, it's that Ronnie Brown is kind of a more guy who's going to pound you, and Carnell's going to make you miss a little bit more. Look at those three sharp cuts. I mean, just changing direction inside the hole and gaining a couple extra yards. He's about 20 pounds lighter than Ronnie Brown, but maybe a little quicker and able to make people miss a little bit more.
Here's Campbell going deep for Obumanu. And there's Obumanu. And there is a touchdown.
Well, there was movement. But I think it might have been offsides on Tennessee.
Flag is at the 43-yard line.
Yeah, there was movement at the line of scrimmage. But I think it was offsides. And Auburn stayed with the play and got the touchdown.
90. Offsides. Penalty is declined. Touchdown.
Jason Campbell. My goodness. They got Turk McBride again, number 90. He's the one who was offsides earlier, just didn't get back out of the neutral zone. Now, he quit on the play. He stayed on his knee. Jason Campbell went ahead and ran the play and threw the touchdown to Obumanu.
Obumanu, Campbell. Here's Vaughn with the extra point. Well, when Jason Campbell goes beyond 300 yards for the first time in his career, he really goes beyond. 374 yards for the senior, the son of a high school football coach, Jason Campbell, Taylorsville, Mississippi.
Do you believe in Santa Claus?
Absolutely.
He helped me pick this up.
This holiday, show her you believe in her. With the Leo Diamond, handcrafted by the artisans at Leo Schachter. The first diamond to be independently measured and certified for its superior fire, sparkle, and brilliance. And like all diamonds at Kay, every Leo is hand-selected to match beautifully.
Can I give you folks a lift?
Every kiss begins with K.
Holiday greetings from Budweiser. From our family to yours, we wish you a very safe and happy holiday season.
In a world where unfortunate events happen to people all the time.
How very, very awful.
How unfortunate it would be to not have that insurance. Lemony Snicket's a series of unfortunate events. In theaters December 17th. Aflac, how unfortunate it would be not to have it.
Crystal.
Auburn. Another touchdown pass by Jason Campbell. Now watch when McBride jumps off sides here. Watch the rest of the Tennessee defense just kind of stop, thinking the play was over. They all stop, and Ben Obumanu keeps running the route. He runs right past Rashawn Fellows. Jason Campbell doesn't stop, and they get a touchdown. The Tennessee players, for whatever reason, thought the play was done. Thought he made contact, thought the play was ruled dead. The official didn't see it that way. And touchdown for Auburn. See, well, I think what Turk is thinking is that he made contact and it should have been a blown dead, but I didn't see him make contact, and neither did Jason Campbell.
Jason Campbell in the record book, 431 yards. That's out of a total of Auburn's 523. And the kick sends Riggs back 9 yards deep. It'll come out to the 20-yard line. Now the lineup for Sunday night on CBS will begin with 60 Minutes and an interview, a rare interview with Bob Dylan. That's followed by Cold Case, then Joe Mantegna and Gene Smart star in an original holiday movie, A Very Merry Christmas, Sunday on CBS, America's most watched network. First and 10, Rick Clawson. There you see the total for Auburn. That is an SEC championship game record. This is Gerald Riggs. Well, Auburn trying to vault over either USC or Oklahoma. USC won today. Oklahoma is winning at the half. And you see the scoring margin for the three teams, very comparable. Strength of schedule. According to the NCAA, Auburn's strength of schedule is ranked ninth, and that despite the fact that they played Louisiana Tech, the Citadel, here's a run up the middle, and Louisiana Monroe. I think you should also point out, though, that if they win tonight, as Tommy Tuberville was quick to mention to us, they will have defeated four teams with nine victories. Now, one of those teams is Tennessee that they've beaten twice. But when they won their signature victories this year against LSU, against Tennessee, against Georgia,
right,
all three at the time were ranked in the top 10. First down and 10. McClure goes to the left side. They try to fake reverse and hand it off, and this time Auburn is ready for it.
Now, I know that they're only down 10, but I don't know how many times Tennessee can continue to just run the football with 5 minutes and 45 seconds now left in the ballgame. I think they've got to get a few more bigger plays, attempt to get some bigger plays throwing the football, because the clock is working against them now, even though it's just a 10-point ball game.
Clawson's numbers rather modest, 7 of 18 for 64 yards. Second and 7 here. They hand it off to Riggs. He's hit behind the line, breaks the initial tackle of Quentin Groves, and is stopped. It'll be third down now. There's Groves, number 54. Nearing the 5 minute mark, Auburn by 10. Third and 7. Crowd of just under 75,000. Nobody's left. This play fairly meaningful.
Yeah, they got to call timeout.
Randy Sanders said call time. Rick Clawson did.
And here's Randy and Trooper Taylor. They looked like they were doing jumping jacks. Instead, they got the timeout. They want to talk about this very important third down play.
4:39 remaining. The margin of difference is 10.
Your shoes will be dyed. Nails.
It's amazing the sacrifices you'll make for friendship. With Diet Dr. Pepper, you sacrifice nothing. Diet Dr. Pepper tastes more like regular Dr. Pepper.
You eyeballing me, Martinez?
No.
Okay, let's get married.
Create your own holiday feast at Red Lobster. Combine two or three of your seafood favorites from 11 signature dishes, including our tender snow crab. Turn a meal into a celebration at Red Lobster.
Funds from the Hartford for people who are always thinking ahead. Ask your advisor.
That for the kids?
Yeah, I just got them some sweaters.
I just got us all on the Verizon Wireless Family Share Plan with M. That way they can talk to their friends all they want. Good luck with that.
Good luck with this.
Sign up for the Family Share Plan and the whole family can make unlimited in-calls to each other and any other Verizon Wireless customer from within the America's Choice coverage area. Plus, buy one LG VX3200 for $19.99 and get up to three free.
Thanks, Mom.
Thanks, Mom.
Verizon Wireless, we never stop working for you.
Why would Bob Dylan break his long silence?
The common perception was that I was either a drunk or a sicko.
The answer in a rare interview, Sunday.
NCIS follows the completion of the 2004 championship game on CBS. Scheduled for 10, 9 Central. You'll see it all as soon as this game is complete. Third and 7. Now this could be the Volunteer season. If they don't convert here, very close to lights out. Auburn's coming with the blitz. Carlos Rogers, pass near side. Brett Smith, hit twice, hit three times, down short. And I don't think they've got much choice but to go for it here. What do you think?
Well, yeah, I think they have to at this point. I mean, they got some of the yardage. It was third and seven. There's a blitz coming from the outside. Carlos Rogers, but it's picked up. And then Brett Smith trying to fight for extra yardage. And you see the speed. That was a defensive lineman. That was T.J. Jackson, number 58, who ran out there from his inside tackle position to make the tackle.
Fourth and three. Balls go for it. At their own 44, down by 10. Less than four to play.
And Randy Sanders calling this play from the sideline. You saw Rick Clawson look over, get the check, communicate it to the rest of the team.
Here comes the corner blitz again. The pass is incomplete. Intended for Brown.
They had the blitz beat. If they have an accurate throw, they get the conversion. Again, this is only Rick Clawson's third game that he started. At times he's been accurate, at times he's not been accurate. This one he could have thrown better. Well, what an effort by Philip Fulmer's team. I'm impressed with what they've done. And I've been impressed with this team all season long.
They are now 3 minutes and 43 seconds away from becoming the first team in the history of football at Auburn University to win 12 games. Handoff, Cadillac Williams. How's that for a championship run to the 35-yard line?
We've seen this miss opportunity a couple times. The blitz comes, Clawson sees it, he sets his feet, but just is not able to make the connection with Tony Brown. Now, whether the receiver wasn't quite in the right spot or whether the throw is off, but if they make that throw and catch, they convert the fourth down. And as it is, Auburn gets the football.
Nearing the 3 minute mark, backs in the eye. Second and two. Cadillac Williams darts through inside the 35 to the 34-yard line. Here's Auburn Tigers SEC championship season. You see 89, 10 and 2. 88, 10 and 2.
Yeah, and this one here, 87, is the last time they won it outright, which if they win here tonight, that'll be an outright championship.
Time has been called by Tennessee. That leaves them with one. Auburn by 10.
What am I? Am I a basketball player who's a psychology major? Or am I a psychology major who's a basketball player? You know, that's the thing about psychology. You tend to overanalyze everything.
There are over 360,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
I believe that this is a practical world.
And that I can count only on what I earn.
Therefore, I believe in work.
Hard work.
I believe
in my country.
In my country.
In my country.
In my
country.
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 I believe in Auburn and love it.
Thursday.
Go!
The ultimate winner of this challenge ends up in the final four, guaranteed. A new Survivor Thursday and the season finale CBS Sunday.
Back in Atlanta, let's take a look at the play of the game presented by Wrangler 5-Star Premium Denim. Here is Rod Bramlett of the Auburn Radio Network.
Second down. Campbell takes the snap. Another flag on the play. Campbell's going to go deep for Obamanu. Near sideline. It's caught. He's in. Touchdown, Auburn. 43 yards.
That's our Wrangler five-star play of the game, Jason Campbell of the Auburn Tigers. Campbell, one of 17 seniors, a graduate, one of seven seniors on this team who've already earned their degrees. Trying to complete the dream season in regular season and championship play with a bowl game to come. Third and one. Left side. Cadillac Williams dives for it.
What an effort.
How about that?
What a second effort. I don't know that I've seen a better short yardage or goal line runner than Carnell Williams in college football in the last several years. I mean, he just knows how to fight for that much needed short yardage play. You see, Tommy Tuberville says that should do it. Had a chance to go to Auburn on Wednesday of this week and watch them practice again. I've just loved the focus of the team the whole season. They've just taken one game at a time all year. A chance to go.
Here's first down. Running play. Williams breaks a tackle inside the 20. Another first down.
Tennessee right now maybe trying to strip the ball and trying to tackle the football, and that's hard to do against Carnell Williams. You better tackle him because he breaks a lot of tackles, and if you're in there reaching for the football and not wrapping him up, he's just going to run right through you, and that's what he did on that play.
That is an even 100 yards on 19 carries for Carnell Williams. 38-28, 1:43 to go. The Auburn Tigers were tied by Tennessee, 21-all. Jason Campbell threw for a touchdown to Aroma Shadu to reestablish the lead. It got back to within three. It's now 10 with 90 seconds to play. Left side. Ronnie Brown, another of the seniors, to the 16-yard line. Well, Tom Tuberville said, I can't imagine a team going undefeated for the season and through the SEC and winning the SEC championship and not getting a chance to play for the national championship. My guess is that's what's going to happen. Yeah. USC won again today. Oklahoma winning big at the break. This is an Auburn team that was ranked 17th in the preseason polls, while USC and Oklahoma were ranked 1 and 2. It would appear they're going to wind up third. Ronnie Brown.
Well, I still think that the SEC, even though it may be a little bit down this year, is still the best conference in college football and the toughest to win, particularly on the road in the conference. And to go undefeated in this league, that is very, very special.
Last loss for this Auburn team was against Georgia last year. It was then that a plane took off and flew to Louisville. Four men on that plane. They offered Bobby Petrino this man's job. Tommy Tuberville came back. The team defeated Alabama. He said he thought he was gone until that victory. And then with a great degree of class, he said he wanted to stay on. I'm not sure what these guys
were doing. Well, they headed to the locker room. The only problem, they went to the wrong locker room. Now they're running all over the place. Oh, they're going to get the flag and the cheer, but more power to them. What a great, great season for the Auburn Tiger football team. What a season for that guy right there, Jason Campbell. No quarterback has played better than him all season in college football.
Let's go down to Tracy Wolfson.
Thanks a lot, Vern. Coach, after everything that happened last year, now an SEC championship victory, a 12-0 perfect season, have you made your case for a national championship?
Well, we played good tonight. I tell you, Tennessee came to play in the second half. They caught us doing some things that we hadn't done all year long, but I don't know. We won't care about the national championship right now. We're going to savor this moment, 12-0, first time ever in Auburn history. One reason, because this guy's standing right over next to us.
Thanks a lot. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Well, our player of the game, Jason Campbell. Look at those gaudy stats. 27 of 35, 374 yards, three touchdowns. And he leads his team to an unblemished season, 12-0. The final 38-28 coming up next, NCIS. For Tracy Wilson, Todd Blackledge. I'm Vern Lundquist saying goodbye from the Georgia Dome, where the Auburn Tigers win it by 10.
On the newest CSI, about a New York Minute. See how it all began with the first episode.
Gotcha.
CSI New York, Wednesday.
The network more people turn to for the best in sports television. The year-round leader is CBS Sports.
Cold